Good afternoon, friends. I welcome you to this very special and unique program on research. And I am overwhelmed by the response and the participation we have got. I am fortunate that we have with us our Vice President of ICICA, Niharbhai Jambusaria. My colleagues in the office bearers and colleagues in the regional council, CA Lalit Bajaj, Chairman, CA Murtuza Bhai Kachwala, Secretary, CA Manish Gadia, Regional Council Member. We have the panelists also with us, CA Subhash Desai, starting with who is going to be the moderator and the speaker for the session. We have CA Sangeeta Pandit, CA Siddharth Purohit, who is the coordinator, CA Alok Shah, Dr. Paritosh Basu, and so we have a power-packed presence today for this very unique topic on research. I would now invite and request our chairman to kindly give his opening remarks.
Thanks, Vishal Bhai. Vice President CA Nihar Jambusaria Ji, a very kind-hearted and a brotherly figure for all of us at Institute and Regional Council. He will share his thoughts as far as research subject is concerned, and at the same time, he will share various initiatives of ICI as far as research is concerned. We have with us Subhash Desai Ji, expert on the subject, and who is also participating in the research committee of WIRC and is helping us in taking various initiatives on research side of WIRC. We have a panel discussion wherein we have with us experts and renowned personality on the subject. Dr. Paritosh Basuji, senior professor and chairperson of MBA Law, MMIMS University School of Business Management. CA Sangeeta Pandit, Dr. Sangeeta Pandit, HOD Finance, Sydenham Institute of Management. Professor Ketan R. Upadhyay, Department of Accounting and Financial Management in a university at Baroda. And our professional colleague, CA Dr. Alok Shah. And coordinator Siddharth Purohit, who seems to be rankist in CA final exam and is an IIM pursuant and in his last year of IIM, and he has really helped us in designing all this research program. So I, with all my regional council members, welcome all of you and all the participants in this virtual meeting on research techniques and career prospects. At WIRC, we have been really blessed to be guided by our Vice President CA Nihar Jambusaria Ji, who has really enriched us on taking some of the initiatives which we were not engaged in before. Let me tell you one thing, this is first ever meeting in WIRC on research activity, and I am happy to share with all of you that we have a huge participancy of around 1500 members, and we are really fortunate and enriched that in future we will be able to conduct more and more such kind of events. We have started this year with some industry specific research activity wherein all our branches have really helped us in coming out with some of the research papers wherein we are in the process of compiling and coming out with the really usable booklet or say compilation. Within some time we will announce that. At the same time, we have recently announced, we have asked all our branches to do some research activity on the subject ease of various registrations in establishing a unit and investments in India by foreign entities. Because as of now, we have seen that there is a lot of talk happening as far as investments shifting from Chinese territory to other territories. So we thought that we can enrich our professional members to really equip themselves on the subject and provide better services to the clients. With this, without taking much of the time, we have lot many initiatives and activities at WRC. I believe you are going through the website and our newsletter and getting updated on the activities. Do participate and be actively take part in our activities. With this, I once again welcome all of you and look forward for a very enthralling session on research, which will really help us to conduct some of our initiatives successfully in near future. Thank you.
Thank you, Lalit Bhai. I would now request our Vice President, CA Nihar Bhai Jambusaria, to kindly share his thoughts and vision.
Thank you, Vishal Bhai. Chairman WIRC, CA Lalit Bajaj, Vice Chairman, CA Vishal, Secretary, CA Murtuza, Treasurer, CA Anand, Regional Council Member, CA Manish, all the researchers, they are all doctors, and I am not doctor. I still have only one degree CA. So these doctors will definitely give us medicine on how to conduct research. In fact, let me tell you, at the beginning of this year at the council, probably it was telepathy that we realized that we need to encourage research in some very serious manner. And therefore, in the research committee, we set a separate budget that the manner in which UGC gives grant for conducting research. The institute has also this year through its research committee set a program that all those who come forward for serious research will be given a grant. Now, this grant may not be a major incentive because all chartered accountants earn enough, but this grant would definitely be helpful in meeting the expenditure that they would be genuinely required to incur on research. Today we have so many researchers, and I have seen that among chartered accountants generally there is a misconception about research, and many of them think that if I write an article on a particular subject, then it is a research article. So research is not something akin to writing an article on a subject. And let me tell you, the roots of research, if I remember, my articleship days were sown during articleship itself. Today, most of the students who register as article students, whenever they are given any work, they refer to Google. From Google, they find out and they try to find an answer to whatever issue is raised to them. Actually, according to me, this is not the right procedure. I remember the day when I started my articleship and I was asked to prepare computation of income. And you know, my colleague, senior article student, gave me a ready reckoner that you refer to this and try to prepare computation. And while I was referring to ready reckoner, my boss, my principal passed by me. He saw me referring to ready reckoner. He pulled it from me and kept Income Tax Act in place of it. He said, whenever you start learning anything, you should learn from original material, make research, and that only will help you clear your fundamentals and concepts. By research, what we mean is that there are various topics and subjects on which we deliberate at surface level, and that does not give us what we really require and want. So if at the institute research is promoted in the right perspective, and if we have guides like today's faculties who have done PhD, they know how to do it. Like when you conduct a research, first synopsis are invited, which would indicate how much serious you are. In the synopsis, there would be a lot of suggestions from the guide. Incorporating those suggestions, the research student would be guided properly what material to refer, what kind of survey to conduct, and how to develop a thesis. So I'm sure that today all these experienced persons will guide chartered accountants who are present at this meeting as to how to conduct research, make it more effective, and see that the user gets the ultimate result which is expected. Now, today, if I give one or two examples where the country needs us, government needs us, business needs us. In COVID period, economy has already taken downturn. Now, government has major task of revival of economy. On revival of economy, if we make thorough research and submit to the government, it will be a big value add from our profession. Take another example, MSMEs. You take example of some shops, some restaurants, some saloons, some shops or theaters in malls. Many of them are on the verge of closure. How to encourage them to survive, restart, what kind of finances would be available, and what is the research material which would actually help them realize that they can still continue, restart, and thrive after COVID-19. So there are various subjects in which research can be conducted. As accountants, we may feel that we should conduct research on accrual system of accounting or say some aspect of tax. These are certainly there. These are core areas of our practice, and we should and need to conduct research. Today in the evening, we have meeting with Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog, and there are several international speakers on accrual system of accounting in government sector. Why it is necessary and how without accrual system, they have single entry system. So they do not know what are the assets and liabilities of the nation, and they are taking decisions in the dark. So in order to help them, we started with the government in Indian Railways. They have already implemented accrual system. In some of the municipal corporations, they have already done it. Now we are giving them the research material. Let's see, if you do not adopt accrual system of accounting even now, where the country will go and how you will be taking decisions in the dark. So there are various subjects. I have given examples of very few. But here, these experts who are there will guide our members what are the areas in which they can conduct research, what is the methodology of conducting research, and how we as chartered accountants build our career through research and at the same time help the society, business, and government by conducting effective research. I'm sure you will do very serious work. And this is what the institute should do and provide to the society, business, and government. These are my thoughts, which I thought before you start discussing the topic, let me put before you and share the views. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity and inviting me for sharing some of my thoughts. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Nihar Bhai. I would now request our secretary, CA Murtuza Bhai Kachwala, to kindly propose a vote of thanks to the vice president, sir.
Thank you, Vishal Bhai. Nihar Bhai, thank you very much for joining us. And we know during COVID also, you are coming to ICAI office every day, and there is so many activities which are going on in back-to-back council meetings and the calls which you are on to spare your time out of that and join us on this really different type of a unique topic where we have 1500 registration and as we can see 1200 are already in and with so many senior faculty and sir, the words of wisdom, you set a foundation in terms of letting us know your thoughts so that we can work on it, and we give you an assurance that we'll definitely do work on this research area and come up with something unique during this year and during your presidentship next year as well. So thank you very much, sir. And we are extremely grateful on behalf of WRC. We thank you once again, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Over to you, Vishal.
I will leave after some time. I'll be there for some time, but then because there is back-to-back meeting, so I may have to.
Sure. Thank you, Niharbhai.
Thank you.
Friends, we move on. And we have with us CA Subhashbhai Desai, a very senior member, who is going to take us through the research with a practicing career as well as the industry career. Before we listen to his words of wisdom, I would request my regional council colleague, CA Manish Gadia, to kindly introduce him.
Thank you, Vishal bhai, for giving this opportunity. So Dr. C. Subhash Desai is really a very good researcher and academician. He is MCom, CA and PhD and practicing chartered accountant in the last 34 years. And he is a trained 26 CA article who became CA now. And teaching also he has a teaching experience of 30 years, and he was visiting faculty with business school, including Wellinker Institute and ICI. Apart from that, he is also managing trustee of Muralidhar Mandir Trust since last 15 years, advisor to Dhupkar Pratishthan, which is an educational charitable trust, director of Global Human Research Foundation Thane. List is very, very, very long. He is also ex-member of Taxation Committee of FICCI. The list is very long. I'm not going into that. And as far as research experience is concerned, he has guided 19 students who later on became PhD, awarded PhD, giving assistance to 8 research scholars to be awarded PhDs. Publication of more than 45 research papers in national and international research journals, organized research seminar national and international on more than 20 occasions in India and Mauritius, Dubai, Thailand, etc. So you can see the rich experience what he has in the field of research. So with this few words, I request all the participants to welcome him with loud applause. Over to you, Vishal bhai.
Thank you, Manish bhai. I would now request CA Subhashbhai Desai to kindly share his thoughts and his views and his deliberations also, please.
Sure. I will take 1 minute, sir.
Sure, sir.
Thank you very much, Vice Chairman Niharji. He has introduced this subject in a manner that he told that he doesn't know anything in research, but he knows more than what we panelists are. Mr. Lalitji, he has initiated this research topic as a, you know, wind up for my practicing and the industrial career topic. And this particular, I took more interest and I told him that if we can do it, and he has really taken that issue, and we are definitely going to see this particular topic, research, practicing, and industry career. This is in the entire my particular session, I am going to go through what is research, what are the chartered accountant scope of work as far as the practice and the industry is concerned, and how this research is going to help the chartered accountants for pursuing their practicing career as well as in the industry career. What is this research process? Because unless that particular is known, the particular concept of research won't be possible. Then what are the various types of the research reporting formats and some of the illustrative areas of topics by a research by a chartered accountant? Now, in a very simple manner, this particular research is nothing but finding out something new. We may call it that as innovation, or finding some existing thing in a different manner which would benefit to the society, and that is called research. And the research always turn around, or rather go around the research problem. All the problems are not research problem. the problem where there are standing operating procedures are available, the problems where there is a ready-made solutions are there are never considered as research problem. And what Nihal ji has told, the same thing, that any RIA paper is not a research paper. In research paper, either you are finding something new or maybe what is called giving a thought to the existing thing in a different manner so that society is going to help. And we chartered accountants are a link between the lawmakers and our clients, which is nothing but a society. Our areas of work definitely help the government in formulating the various principles in various acts, in various procedures, as well as modify the particular acts and the procedures by virtue of which principally these procedures would help the particular government to build their exchequer. At the same time, our clients or the society in general would benefit by virtue of this. And that's why the concept of research is very important for the purposes of our chartered accountant fraternity. Yesterday only, I had one occasion to what is called go through one's pre-thesis viva, of which I was the moderator. That particular person has completely dwelled with section 263, 64, as well as 143, as well as article 14. And he has done such a wonderful thesis. He is also our fellow chartered accountant. And that particular is also the area where the chartered accountants can do. And we are going to go through my entire process and entire discussion on the research would link to whatever the topics which are there for the purposes of a researcher, as well as the industry or maybe the what is called the practicing career is concerned. My particular slide displays research is a very systematic inquiry. Systematic means nothing but you should go in deep as far as how to that particular research problem is by way of describing, explaining, as well as predicting in a very scientific manner, so that whatever the information which you are giving as a report would be reliable. And that is the essence of any type of the research. And that's why research and writing a report is not the same. That's why it requires lots of work, lots of characteristics, lots of what is called scientific thing, so that the particular whatever the things would come out of that particular research would be beneficial to the audience. Audience can be anybody, as far as the government is concerned, society is concerned, or anything. And that particular is nothing but that. What is the purpose of research? Any type of the research, and this is definitely related to my CA profession also. Research is conducted with a purpose. Now, when I called a purpose, then what do the organization or business really want to find out? Oh, this is nothing but a research problem. See, anything which is existingly the standing operating procedures or the rules and procedures are giving the answers is not a research problem. For example, now the COVID situation has made a wonderful opening for our chartered accountants to go through the various processes by virtue of which the industry chartered accountants also, and our Niharji has already told about that yes, the investment, there is a flow of investments in India, and the industry people can make this particular type of the problem as a research problem and go around what are the various types of the variables. When I called variables, that means nothing but whenever India is what is called, whenever our problem is to have the investment analysis and bring that into India, and that will ultimately benefit the industry to which I am serving, is nothing but there are various alternatives are there which can be called as independent variable. And solving the particular real problem that bringing the investment is my dependent variable. And that's why there are various processes that need to be followed for chasing this idea. Same thing is about the debt management. Any industry person, when he is working for the industry, nowadays, sir has also told that this particular debt management or the cost of the particular finances need to be brought down in this particular COVID area in particular and in general also. And that particular research has to be done so that our cost of the funds would be there, which will be minimum. And that particular, how many types of the finances are available? Those are nothing but the building of the various variables. The success of the researcher depends upon how many independent variables you bring into the existence so that you are finding out a solution to your dependent variable. That is the thing which is there. For example, if I have to go to Bombay to Pune, I got multiple options to go to Pune. Train or maybe a bus, or maybe there are so many ways by virtue of which I am going. I should list out everything, and my particular what is called problem is to save my cost as well as time, and what is the prominence according to which I will what is called choose that particular independent variable by following a process which is nothing but a data analysis and whatever building the objectives, etc. My third area, or rather the purpose of the research, is to build some objectives on the basis of this, and that's why the research is called science. Science is nothing but an organized study into the problem whereby the solutions would be reliable to the users of the community. And that's why the arguments that need to be built around a particular concepts are nothing but the objectives, and based on that objectives, hypotheses are built. Of course, for each objective, there is no what is called hypothesis are there. Example, that particular person who has given a pre-thesis viva has done a case study approach and built an objective about how to improve that 263, 264 and redundant provisions about the clause A has to be modified. That particular, there is no hypothesis, but still that particular he could build up by following a data analysis approach of case study approach, and that particular was wonderful. So this is, there is not necessity that everything can be have a hypothesis, which we are going to see later on. Then we will collect the various types of the evidences which are required for the people to believe in that idea or concept. Now here there are many problems. Now see here, the population is very big. First of all, we need to define the population. That suppose I am going for the industry, then I choose the particular industry where I am going to do that particular analysis. Industry, how many operators, and out of that operators or the companies, out of which particular type of the company that particular I will choose for the purposes of analysis is nothing but my sample size. And that particular population is nothing but the industry where I want to make a research. And that particular data, once it is collected through various modes, in the cases of quantitative analysis, by virtue of floating the questionnaires, which should be built up in a very systematic manner. Otherwise, the results, whatever those are given, would be fantastically not at all usable. That's what I saw in case of number of students who are I am teaching, or rather whatever I am teaching them, encouraging to do research. That's why the questionnaire has to be built up in a very systematic manner, where the open-ended questions need to be avoided, and the question should give a manner whereby it can lead to further analysis as far as the statistics is concerned, and that analysis would depend upon the use of various statistical tools such as test of significance, and that particular would be reliable, and the sample size has to be sufficient in order to reflect the attitude, or rather the behavior of the population, and that's why that can be relied upon, and that is the thrust of any type of the research. I will go to the next slide. What are the various characteristics of the research? Now, characteristics of the research is nothing but a systematic approach must be followed for accurate data. Rules and procedures are integral part of the process that set is the objective. Now, example, a practicing chartered accountant has come across various types of the clients complaints that, sir, ye barabar nahi ho raha hai, humko isme bahut dikkat aa rahi hai, and we cannot collect this type of the data and all this. And there are some flaws in the particular type of the, you know, the procedures, principles, or maybe the act, maybe the rules, maybe the circulars, whatever those may be. So here the practitioner can do a research having a sample of the particular clients and float the questionnaire, or maybe with interview method, he can collect the data through such questions, which would lead to a very accurate type of the data, for which the rules and the procedures need to be built up very, very minutely. And that's why then the results can come very reliable. Research is based upon logical reasoning only. Data or the knowledge, whichever is derived in the real time from the actual observations in the natural settings, yes, that should be there. And that's why whatever the particular data which is collected should be unbiased, in a sense that we should not force the particular respondent to give a particular view of our choice, but that we should come out with a real type of the answer to the relevant questions which are being asked in the cases of the particular questionnaire or maybe the interview, and then that particular would what is called give a good type of the results can come out. There is an in-depth analysis of the data collected so that there are no anomalies associated with. Why I'm telling you? Because in the cases of the industry, chartered accountant, those who are working in the industry, they require to give a report to their CEOs or whatever the top of people are there. That report need to be given in a proper format so that the particular company can take the particular problem in a manner which would be constructive as well as giving the what is called assistance to the industry in reaching out some conclusion which would be beneficial to that particular type of the industry, like cutting down the cost, etc. Example, now this particular data, if that particular is data about the waste, some person is what is called investigating the cost of the what is called product, in which is the cost of the material is a prominent factor, and it is utmost necessary to cut down the cost as far as the material is concerned, whereby you can do a research, whereby you can make a what is called analysis about what are the various prices, cost, processes, as well as the what is called cost of transport, cost of insurance. Many things are there which are called independent variable, and collate upon that, and thereafter make an in-depth analysis about the data so that you can come out and give your assistance to your industry CEOs or maybe the top of people so that they can control the cost, which is nothing but conserving the actual very acute resources and cut down the cost so that your money is saved, which would be really beneficial to our nation and which would increase the GDP in a real sense. That is the thing what we are interested. Research creates a path for generating new questions. See, any problem when you are solving, it would create further problems also, which would be a part of the what is called further research. You cannot what is called do a research on all the types of the questions at a time. And that's why in our research format, there is a what is called what is the further scope as far as any type of the problem is concerned, that particular need to be given. Research is analytical in nature. See, analytical nature, it makes use of all available data. Data can be gathered, as I told you, through the questionnaire, through what is called Google, data which can be gathered, Google form which are circulated, or maybe through the what is called interviews and so on. And all such data, whenever that particular is gathered, there should not be any type of the ambiguity. Ambiguity in a sense that your data presentation in the form of your tables gives something different, whereas your analysis gives some different result. And that's why we always advise our students or those who are scholars to go ahead with what is called a pilot data, so that you can get the responses in a manner which would not be ambiguous, so that either you can have to modify the particular questionnaire or maybe go ahead with new questionnaire or discard that one. And that is the thing which is there always. Accuracy is one of the most important aspects of the research, and this accuracy would be possible when we are using the science, that is statistics, for the purposes of making the analysis and the various tools whatever we are using, tables, graphs, or maybe the various test of significance, which I still remember in my days, because I passed out in 1986. Before that, there was a subject called operations research where much thrust was on statistics and many statistical tools were being asked. I don't know about this current trend. Now, information that is obtained should be accurate and true so that it can give a purposeful, what is called, results for the users to take some action. And that is the purpose of any research. The audience can be anything. Audience can be your company, your CEO. Ultimately, the society is going to help. Your audience can be either your or your what is called a government. When you are making a research in respect of the various procedures, various principles, various types of the acts and the rules where there is an ambiguity, and you are making that particular research, that particular the data, whatever that you got gathered with the case help clause, etc., and that particular will help the government in formulating or redrafting that particular law, which will be useful. And that's why the accuracy is one of the very important aspects of the research. Three of the chartered accountants who have done research under me, one is a gold medalist as far as the particular is concerned. She had done the research when GST was coming into existence. There was no way that we were sure about whether the GST will come or not because of the changes in the political system. but I forced her to do that particular research, and she got a wonderful beginning. And this one in one of the very big bank and GST, when she completed the research, after that one the GST came into the picture, but they were asked, and that is the what is called the purpose, or rather the uses of the research for making an advancement in your career also. Second, what is called the particular type of the research has done in international law, other than has done in a general topics. Now there are two types of the research, and most of us are going to do in the quantitative research, not qualitative research. Quantitative research is nothing but collecting the data and analyzing to draw the conclusions. Unlike a qualitative method, the method uses a conceptual and statistical process to collect and analyze the related data. And that quantitative data is all about numbers. Yes, because we are asking our, as a practitioner, we are asking so many questions which are arranged in a manner whereby the results can come with the related to the objectives, because we always see what are the objectives. In relation to that objectives, what are the hypotheses, whatever we have built. And in relation to the objectives, the relevance of that to the questionnaire, whichever is being built up, so that meaningful results can come by virtue of the analysis of the data, and that particular would help. And that is why we are more thrust is on quantitative. I am not touched upon the qualitative research. Quantitative research involves larger population, more people means more data. Now here there are many problems. Kya hoga ye population and kya hoga that particular sample size. See, population is nothing but you choose to limit yourself to a particular type of the situation. Example, I done my research in the insurance. I selected the population of Mumbai. Now in Mumbai, that means my population was entire population of Mumbai. And I made a comparative analysis of, the nationalized companies as well as non-nationalized company. So out of that, I selected the what is called policyholders, which when are being given or floated the questionnaire, then such results or rather the numbers selected out of the what is called the population, the results should come by whereby which it should be representative of the population, then and only it can be accurate. What size of the data would be reliable? Larger the sample size, larger the larger the sample size, more accurate, but that is not always correct. There are many things which are there, and the floor is not that whenever the particular entire this lectures will come, that time we will discuss about that. What are the various formulas for selecting the number of samples, whether that data is stratified or not, and all such questions are related to that. That's why I leave that. Only thing that the results obtained on the basis of the sample should be reliable in a sense that that should be indicative about the population from which the particular samples is drawn. With more data to analyze, you can obtain more accurate result. That is a general thumb rule. This method uses close-ended questions. Always they should be close-ended, whether you like it or not, yes or no, or whether you are this one. So that particular way. But suppose you are asking a particular respondent to give your views, then that particular is not close-ended, and that cannot be what is called quantified in terms of, a statistical analysis, and that particular would not be useful for the purposes of the research. Online surveys, questionnaires, and polls. These are the common variety. Even in the cases of the, online surveys can be done through the Google floated. Nowadays, we cannot meet people because of the COVID conditions. And that's why more and more thrust is on the Google questionnaires, which are given by through the Google. And the data is collected, which is analyzed. And that particular would be even the questionnaires which are floated and the polls which are conducted are the preferable data. In addition to that, there are many things like the you can ask, because many CEOs are reluctant to fill the questionnaires, surveys and polls. So what they prefer, they want a particular interview to be taken, and during that interview, whatever the answers which are given should be what is called taken, and that particular would help the particular results to come out in a very great manner. There are various methods of deploying surveys or the questionnaires, which that particular we are not what is called going at this present. After this particular slideshow, we will go ahead with the research methodology or research process. That particular would help a particular chartered accountant to go ahead with his research job. Now, these are not the areas in all as far as the particular chartered accountant scope of work in practice or industry is concerned. Yes. Accountancy is the area. In accountancy, there are lots of principles are there, lots of auditing standards or lots of accounting standards are there, lots of FIRS is also there, so that the valuation terms which are different, rather change in the valuation terms to the fair value and all these concepts are there. That can be also the areas where one can do a research in the cases of accountancy. Even in the cases of COVID, now we cannot physically go to the office. Here now the online working as far as the accountancy is concerned is getting a prominence, and lots of people have come out with a solution to that. Of course, that solution is what is called not tailor-made, but it is universal or generally accepted. But in a company or to your client, you can what is called is a better judge of what the procedures need to be adopted in order to bring out the results accurately, correctly. That particular is our job, so that we can make a research in the changed circumstances, and that particular will help. And there are various lots of areas where we can do research in the cases of the way accountancy, where the principles are involved, standards are involved, as well as the what is called procedures are involved. And such procedures, principles and standard should lead to a better what is called reporting in a manner whereby the government and the users of the particular accounts should be what is called understandable as well as readable and more clear. And that's why the research can be possible in the cases of accountancy. I have given around 50 areas where the research can be done, but I'm touching here only. Even in the cases of audit, how you can cut down the way cost, cut down the way time as far as the audit is concerned, and the various auditing principles what we need to follow, the various types of the ratios what you need to do, and thereafter compare with way of comparison, we can come out with so many things whereby we are subject to lots of professional things where we can devise our own system. Of course, there are guidance notes are there given by the institute which are of great help, but still we can also do the particular research in the various auditing areas so that our audit can be more this one, and our standing and creditability would be far more in the cases of the society. Same thing is about the concept of internal audit, where the management gives a particular chartered accountant to go ahead with your the internal audit in order to what is called improve upon the systems and the procedures, whereby the cost would be reduced as well as the what is called time would be reduced, and the particular would be done in a manner. There also we can do a lots of research through interview with the different type of the people, how they do or how they perform their duties, how they what is called do everything, and that particular is nothing but the concept which will be helpful in the cases of your internal audit. Now this particular forensic audit, Lalit Kumar is taking a lot of interest in the cases of this forensic audit. Lots of seminars are there. Even the data analyst seminars are also being there. I was also one of the participants in that, and that was wonderful as far as that idea software what he launched, and that particular was helpful to many members. Same thing is there in the case of forensic. Frauds are now becoming an order of the day, and that particular chartered accountant's help is required. And we can what is called study many systems, many accounts, many behavior of the those who are responsible for maintaining the accounts and the systems and the procedures, whereby you can work out which are the vulnerable areas as far as the fraud is concerned, and do a research in this which would be helpful for the purposes. See, all the research may not lead to a doctoral degree, but yes, that research can help the particular industry or the company where you are working, as well as the practice where you are what is called doing a practice, and can help you in better discharging your jobs in a manner that particular would give a better results. Same thing is in the cases of income tax. Many people are doing the particular research in the cases of income tax. There are many sections, the provisions, the what is called the notifications, the circulars, as well as the decided cases, whereby many of the sections have become redundant or which requires modifications. The procedures requires modifications. Even in the cases of tax audit, anomaly is there, and all such areas that particular can be dealing. Even one of the income tax officer in Iker Bhuvan is working, or rather doing research with me. And he is doing a research in the cases of income tax because he has got a first hand, and he's a very senior ITO, and he has done a wonderful research whereby government mutates out different types of the scheme for the purpose of increasing their revenue, which is not sufficient. And I bet that particular his particular thesis is going to complete by this December, and he has done such a wonderful thing that is worth. Original thesis is more than 1000 pages, which now I am asking him to what is called reduce, but he has done a wonderful job. So that is also helpful to the department as well as to the society, so that the government exchequer, which is going out of the revenue, and unnecessarily those who are honest taxpayers are paying the tax money, which is not good, and that particular exercise. So there are many types of the things which are there in the cases of income tax, including the tax audits, procedures, principles, acts, provision. Many have done in the cases of international taxation. One of my scholar has done a particular this thing. So there are many areas where the particular research can be done in this case. In the cases of international taxation, I already told, because that is also a new area apart from what is called income tax, where now the globe leave apart this COVID area, but otherwise now the particular barriers of trade are now gone, and that's why we can trade very freely, and that's why the international taxation becomes a very paramount importance, and that's why the FERA and all these things and many things are coming, whereby you can do a lot of research, either you are in the industry or maybe in the cases of your practice. Goods and services tax, lot more than 400 amendments have come in the cases of goods and services tax. Two of my scholars are doing the research in the cases of this. Many where the particular problems are there in the cases of procedures, in the cases of exemptions, the scheduling, and all these things whereby the much of the revenue is lost, the what is called movement of the goods, the point of supply, and so many places where there is a place where you are relating to your company, if you are working there, or if in the practice, the area where your clients are having a problem, then the goods and services tax, you can, it's a very wide area where you can do a research, and that particular could be benefit. Management consultancy is a very, very wide area. And all the these things, and this is coming into the prominence, more and more people are turning into that. And here, cutting down the cost, cutting down the time, betterment in the procedures, and many things the chartered accountants can do by virtue of research, and that particular is possible. My view is only this: a chartered accountant is a link between the, you know, government, those who are the lawmakers or the executors of the law, and the particular society or your clients, and in between you are the link. And chartered accountants, whenever one question always is being asked in the cases of PAD Viva, how your thesis can be helpful to the society? The answer is very simple as far as the chartered accountant is concerned, because anything whatever he does is for the purposes of the society, because he is a link, and he is what is called performing his job in order to increase the revenue, and what is called honest papers are taxpayers are benefited. Accountancy is what is called streamlined, so that the particular procedures would not be what is called much these things, following the, all the principles, etc. And the ultimate what is called the members, or rather the society, or maybe his clients who are benefited because of this particular research. That's why take any area, that particular area is definitely going to what is called help the society to perform better. That is the thing. Now coming to this particular research process, now many things I have discussed, but still identification of the research problem, I again what is called reiterate that any problem should be a problem in the various parameters of a research problem. In other words, ready-made solution is not available. Number two, the standard operating procedures or maybe the laws there does not have any solution to that particular problem, and that's why that particular problem you should be able to define in a better manner. And in order to find out that particular research problem, see that particular no research has been done as far as the particular research problem is concerned. Example, I'll tell you that in this case, you must have what is called scan the existing environment is nothing but a concept of literature review. You must go through various sites such as Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri. There are many sites which are available where you can get a published data in the form of the thesis in the Shodh Ganga, and in the cases of Shodh Gangotri, all the real synopsis, whatever those are published by or rather uploaded in the system by the various university, and you can see whether any problem where the solution is already there or rather published is not your research problem. And that's why much care has to be taken for defining your research problem. Otherwise, you will come to a sad end that whatever you have found out is already the solution is there, and you may be cutting wrong things. And that's why that particular scan the existing environment is nothing but reviewing the literature, reviewing the various types of the articles which are what is called published in various types of the journals. And normally ISSN journals are what is called reliable. And that's why DOAJ, that because I got a wonderful compilation of all research review of literature, I give normally 3 hours lecture on that. So there are many sites where you can get many types of the material, and that particular can be used for the purposes of scanning the existing environment so that your research problem would be strictly research problem. Now, whenever you have defined the research problem, then fix the objectives or the alternatives of the study is nothing but defining the various types of the variables, like the independent and the dependent variable that is already being defined in your objectives, and the independent variable that is various alternatives or various types of the things which you, by virtue of which you want to achieve your objective, are nothing but the independent variables, and study those system by virtue of the either quantitative or qualitative data, and thereafter go ahead with your research. Once you are defined that in a very clear-cut manner, because your report is going to your what is called CEOs or maybe that people, that research report format has to be a proper one, so that this particular would come and that particular would help in a better manner, that particular CEOs can understand better and find this particular solutions reliable, so that he can act upon. Otherwise, he may throw that particular research in their big basket. That's why scan the existing literature, thereafter formulate the hypothesis. I already discussed this. All the what is called objectives are not quantified as hypothesis. And that's why those which can be construed as a quantitative data can be what is called given by way of the hypothesis, which is also a technical term, which we need to what is called prove, which are called null hypothesis as well as alternative hypothesis. And building the null hypothesis is an art. And if that is negated, then alternative hypothesis is accepted. Now the floor is not which is called proper to explain all these types of the hypothesis. But yes, there are various types of the hypothesis which should be constructed on the basis of objective, which what is called give an idea to construct better questions so that the results can come which are far more reliable and subject to the statistical analysis, so that the results would be reliable. And that's why formulation of the various hypotheses are also the particular step has to be done. Then develop your research plan. See, the research plan, if you are doing a PhD, sir has already told that the normally whenever you are doing a research plan, first of all, you review the literature, you review the various sites and see, define your research problem, etc. And after that one, in a snapshot, you give your proposal. And that proposal is discussed and accepted or rejected by the particular VIVA committee. And thereafter you go and what is called give a snapshot of your synopsis. That is a nothing but a 24-26 pages document, whereby you are giving a what is called a snapshot that how my research would go. And this is also possible. You can go ahead and give your CEO the particular research what you are going to undertake, and that particular synopsis also you can give. If he approves, then go ahead. And that is the concept of, you know, devising a research plan, thereafter, you know, planning the sample design. Sample design is nothing but defining the population, defining the samples in a scientific manner. Thereafter, what is called defining the region, defining what is called the what is called sampling process, and all this is nothing but what is called planning for a sample design. That such samples which are selected would be representative of the masses or the population from which it is drawn. And that's why if your data is stratified means what? Suppose your things are related to a lower income, higher income, thereafter the more higher income, or maybe what is called a very poorest class, then in all these cases those are called stratified what is called the population, and a sufficient sample should be drawn from each, so that your sampling would be called stratified sampling, and that particular sample, sufficient number of the samples would be indicative of all the stratified details. That is why that is called a good sampling is required. Collect the required information. We already talk about all these things. We must collect this required information by floating a questionnaire, through our Google form or maybe interview method or maybe whatever the methods by virtue of which you have to collect with the required sample, so that the particular in this case the thing which is precedent to this collecting is defining and devising the questionnaire. I would suggest you that devising a questionnaire is not at all a simple task, because whatever the questionnaires you devise should be what is called acceptable, and the results should be what is called reliable. Otherwise, what will happen? And that's why you must take a help of a statistician or the doctor, so that they can help you in logically arranging that particular question, so that the results would come out in an analytical manner, which would help the audience for taking a proper decision, which is our ultimate aim. That audience can be your company head, or maybe what is called the government, or maybe you yourself, because as a practicing chartered accountant, you require that collection of the required information is there. Thereafter, this is nothing but that data, whatever is collected, has to be properly analyzed. See, nowadays that particular in Excel, using the Excel formats without using SPSS or maybe any type of the strata which I am using, that particular without using Excel techniques are available, and you can go ahead and what is called do a lots of jobs on execution of the data. And because many what is called inbuilt processes are there, whereby you can analyze that data for the purposes of our required analysis and use that particular type of the statistical test which are inbuilt in the particular Excel, and that particular can be used and meaningful what is called answers can be given to your hypothesis, whatever you have built up. Testing the hypothesis, I told you. Finding the relevance. Now this finding the relevance is nothing but this actually comes at two stages. Before plotting the questionnaire in a regular manner, you should first of all take a pilot questionnaire of a say 10 to 15 or maybe 30 samples, and thereafter execute that data, process that data and give a results out of that. And that particular relevance, you can find out whether your objectives are in conformity with the objectives what you sought the results for. Otherwise, your entire process of the results would go, because it is a long process. And the second stage is that at the end, when you have found out your what is called complete data, analyze that, use statistical techniques, and thereafter what is called got the what is called results. Those results are relevant to the objectives or maybe your hypothesis, need to be tested, and thereafter clearly give your limitations as far as the what is called collection of your information and your research, because you are not going to see each and every element of the population. That is your first limitation. Second is sometimes the particular that particular person who is giving may not reveal more as far as his data is concerned, and that's why that particular data is strictly based on the collected data is strictly based on the answers given by. Even I suggested to the that particular income tax officer that he prepared the questionnaire in such a way that the particular person to whom the questions are asked will never give the answer. I told that these are not acceptable to me as far as this, because the people when are asked some type of the questions where the answers are not coming, or rather they are giving some false answers, your entire what is called a data collection and the results would what is called is not reliable and would not help to the government or maybe the society as a large. That's why that is required, and that's why finding the relevance is very, very the ideal one. And the last but not least is preparation of the report. That report, there is a separate section which we'll see. And these particular reports, once prepared, suppose you are an industry chartered accountant has done that one, like in the cost reduction or maybe in the finding of some solutions pertaining to the accounting procedures or maybe in the internal audit department, then whatever the particular findings which you have made, three stages you should give always to that. First of all, your what is called basic sketch plan. Thereafter, give a synopsis that what is your proposed research plan, and thereafter what is called the results. And that particular results in the form of the reports, once it is given, those are more authentic, that you already tested that particular, and that's why that particular is called presentation of the results and the findings, because it is required. In case of all these three stages, this particular requires a viva. Either that viva is internal or maybe the through the external panel, depends. Same thing is there in the cases of your what is called research finding in the cases of the industry, or when you yourself are doing, you can give to your partner and ask for that particular, whether that particular is proper or not. so that it can be useful to the chartered accountant as a practitioner to go ahead with his results, or maybe as an industry, that particular to the CEO or this one. Now, what is the type of the research methodology which we should identify? There are many types of the methodology which are there, which I have incorporated in that particular these things. To choose appropriate type of the research, you need to clarify, identify the objectives, some objectives to take into considerations for your business. And that includes find out the needs of your client. That is the most important thing. If your client or whatever your company requires to cut down the cost or to cut down the time is your paramount importance as far as this is concerned, then bringing about your entire research based on what exactly he requires, then that particular research would be meaningful, and your methodology would depends upon actually what the particular your client or your audience requires. Know the preferences and understand what is important to them. That is what I discuss. Find the ways to improve your systems and the procedures to suit the needs. See, this is through the process of collecting, analyzing the data, you will come to know that the systems what you adopted as suggested by somebody, then that particular may not be appropriate with their discussion. You can also always improve the system with the changes in the circumstances, changes in the environment, changes in the law during the process, and that particular would be a proper thing for the purposes of improving upon the systems and procedure to suit the needs as far as the particular your audience is concerned or your customer is concerned or maybe whatever the what is called business it needs. After identifying what you need to know, you should ask what research methods will prefer offer that information. So now we have very clearly decided actually what my particular client wants. Client means the user wants. And now at this stage, once it is defined, then go ahead with the research methods, whether it's a quantitative method, qualitative method, or what. Then define that one, like the person with respect to whom I talk about, 263, 264, 143, 2, and read with Article 14. He has prepared one that was a completely qualitative, and depending upon the case law method, he has analyzed that one. That was a completely type of the qualitative type of the research method he followed. But we can have different types of the things like quantitative, and in which case then we have to define our what is called scope as far as our research methods are concerned. A well-organized custom research process produces valid, accurate, reliable, and timely, and complete. See, all these words are very important for the purposes of the users of the research. Your research results must be first of all valid. If you don't take proper sample, if you don't take a select the samples proper in a sense that if it is stratified from all the strata, then the result would not be accurate. The result would not be what is called reliable. We should not force the what is called the questionnaire, what is called respondents to what is called answer in a manner, then that particular may not be a reliable, and of course timely. I am definitely going to stop my particular lecture at 3:30 because all we professors, when we give a visiting faculty lecture at Management Institute, we know the timing, and that's why I will what is called close at 3:30 sharp. Same is there. If the research report does not come in time and further research somebody has done it, then what is the process and why the particular research and what are the benefit of your research, and that's why it should have a time frame as defined in your research plan, so that the complete results in a timely manner, which is valid, accurate, as well as the reliable would come, and that is the thing which is required. Results that rigorously reflect the opinions and needs of your clients will help you to grow your sales and improve your operations. Here I have told sales, but not sales. In fact, it can relate to any objects for which you are collecting the particular data. It may be what is called accounting procedures. It may be accounting what is called authority levels. It may be devising certain types of the forms whereby the particular accountability of the different subordinates can be pinpointed and do an improvement upon the system, so that your improvement in the system can come through. That is all is nothing but the improvement in your operations would be a object where we are that particular. Either it can come down the cost, it will come down the time, or whatever the objects for which you have done the research. To obtain the results, you need to establish and follow the process that you have detailed out for your organization. See, in your research plan, you always what is called make a plan. That these are the processes which I am going to follow. I am going to what is called follow a particular questionnaire through whatever the methods by virtue of which I am going to float that either through the Google or whatever that. And that process has to be strictly followed, because once you have decided that process, then that particular process need to be what is called followed and detailed out for your organization, so that that particular would be the objectives would be fulfilled. Set your goals. That is a very important thing, because you need to have sub goals. In I have taught the management processes also, where we always tell our students, you for the purposes of making anything, you should have a goal. हमको यही पता नहीं कि कहाँ जाना है, then it is meaningless to ask anybody कि ये रास्ता कहाँ जा रहा है. Same thing is there in the cases of any research. You should have a final goal, and in relation to that final goal, we should have what is called sub goals, and the time frame for the purposes of achieving those goals must be set. Otherwise, your research would not be what is called accurate, or maybe a timely error, or whatever the things which are there. That's why setting your goals is of paramount importance. Consider the objectives of the client and define those that to identify yours. Make sure that you set smart goals and objectives. That is obvious. Do not presume the results of your service. That is never to be done, because many times aapko kya chahiye, this is wrong. आपको क्या चाहिए नहीं, what the results can come out of the samples when you have what is called understood and what is called formulated that yes, this sample size is sufficient, then whatever the results will come from that sample would be representative of the masses or the population, then whatever you thought of may not be what is called the true when you that particular, and such cases that you need to modify, remodify, and that particular can be a further, and that's why do not presume the results. One of my chartered accountant colleague is doing research on the NPA analysis of the particular these things. His research is also in it. So that there are many areas where the chartered accountants can do their research in order to help the banking sector, or maybe the sectors whereby they are working or other practicing, or maybe to the industry as well. So do not presume the results of the surveys. Always the results, whatever those are depicted, on the basis of which your results should come, and your what is called finding should give the particular addressing along with your scope of research. Then plan your research. That is the thing which is there in my process plan. Good planning allows use of creative and logical approaches to select the methods that gather. Of course, this is the paramount importance, and I have just discussed this also, that in way the planning stages, the time and the cost and the budget, whatever you is being set out to you, and that particular process of collecting the objectives, as well as what is called the processes, whatever, need to be properly planned and designed, which is nothing but called a plan of your research. Otherwise, your research will go here or there, and the results would not be coming, which are, if they come, that would not be a proper way of what is called reliability test will be followed. Your plan will be influenced by the type and the complexity of the information you need, the skills of your team, and how soon they need of information. See here, all the data you as a chartered accountants are not going to what is called collect. That's why the team which is what is called with you to collect that data need to be properly trained, and properly should have a skills for the purposes of collecting the data, and whatever the things what we discuss, that the reliability of the information is based on the results what is coming from the surveys, need to be emphasized so that that particular objective would be fulfilled. And that's why how soon you need the information is nothing but a time factor. Your budget also plays a larger role in your ability as far as the collection of data is concerned. Otherwise, you go on starting. Now, Niharji has told that the UGC has grant given a grant for the purposes of, or rather will be giving a grant for conducting various types of the research. But definitely the particular budgets play a very, very important part, timing and the complexity. See here, your plan would what is called give a proper idea that what much the budget which you require and suits that particular for the purposes of going ahead with that. And I what is called appeal from this floor that yes, a larger our chartered accountants, whether they are doctors or not, they should involve themselves for the purposes of conducting the research which would be what is called helpful to the society as well as to their clients, or maybe to their CEOs, or maybe whatever the to the government as the case may be. And that's why they're the setting the budget is a what is called very important for the purposes of that. Then collect and collect. Collect and collect, that means collection of the data should be what is called reliable. And that data, whatever is collected, need to be properly collated so that you can process that data following the statistical techniques in order to bring out the results as far as that particular, whatever the methods you choose for the purposes of obtaining that particular type of the leases. Make a list how you are going to carry out the research process. The data you need to collect and collection method. This has to be clearly has to be defined and known to your team, following your constraint as far as the budget is concerned, and thereafter start and go ahead as far as the collecting the data is concerned. This will help you to keep track of your processes and make sense of your findings. Normally, whenever the particular questionnaires are floated, and if your sample size is say 1000, at each 250 what is called sample size, we go ahead with what is called testing that, so that my particular results are coming or not, and always you are tracking the processes which you thought of are actually being followed in toto would be known to you, so that it will make a sense to your finding. That is the logic of any type of the what is called collect and collect. It will also allow you to verify that your research accurately reflects the opinions of your clients and your market. That is also there. For example, nowadays lots of things are going on that many people are advising to go in the what is called stock market in order to build up their money, and people are following that. If you do a proper research of the industry which is lucrative for the purposes of investing, your research can help many of the people to go and invest in a proper manner. Otherwise the broker's tips etc. are not going to help any type of the clients to go ahead as far as this. And that's why that particular is a paramount importance. Now create a record, what is called table, with the necessary data, the method of data collection, the steps to follow the data analysis, because everything depends upon your collection, what is called collate, preparation of the various types of the tables, and finding a solution on the basis of whatever the objectives and the hypothesis what you have built up, and that would lead to the steps to follow your data analysis. Remember, research is only valuable and useful when it is valid, accurate. This is again, I have to put that sentence. It must be valid. Otherwise, if you have flaws in the cases of the concept of, you know, defining your objectives, defining the needs, not properly building your hypothesis, then the results are and the sample size is not being properly what is called defined, then in all these cases, your KSIR report would be what is called not valid, not accurate, and not reliable. Relying on the imperfect research is dangerous, and because the people will what is called go a misleading way, and that's why it should be avoided, and that particular can lead to a customer churn and a decrease in the sales. That decrease in the sales is associated with any of the objective for which you are doing a particular research. Now it is important to obtain the information about how the collection of information was carried out and to ensure that your data is valid. We have already discussed about that. Valid means what? Validity is judged on the basis of the founded, logical, and rigorous and impartial. Because whenever in the time of the collection of the data, if that data itself is collected in a manner dictating the respondents to answer in a proper the way in which you want the results, then those cannot be valid. If you do not choose the particular type of the samples proper in a strata and did not properly design your what is called research, then in that case also it would not be valid. That's why that care has to be taken. It should be accurate. In a sense that accuracy has to be of paramount importance, because in statistics, the errors of the designed what is called level of significance gives or mars your what is called accuracy. Suppose you have made a test of significance at 5% or rather 1%, then the type of error, because here is the floor is not here to teach me the particular level of significance and all this matters. But yes, that will what is called make the particular whether it is accurate. That is accuracy is nothing but a free of errors and including the required details, and reliable. That can be reproduced by other people who investigate in the same way. Now here at this stage, please understand there are two types of the data which can be used by a researcher. One is called secondary data, and another one is called primary data. Secondary data is nothing but a data which is on the published, what is called data available on the reliable sites like Government of India sites, etc., where you must, what is called, quote what is called that particular source from which you got that particular data, and you can, what is called, use that data for the purposes of your data analysis. That is also possible. And primary data is nothing but know what is called data is available, you actually collecting through a various processes or the methods, whatever the data collection methods, like the questionnaire, interview, or maybe the Google questionnaire, etc. And that's why that particular are called two types of the data are possible, which I somehow missed out, but that particular is also required. Whenever you are using any secondary data, give the source very accurately, correctly. Otherwise, that particular research would be a copy of something and you would come under the plagiarism. That's why that particular is also be there. The another objective of the research is about the timeliness. I explained about that, that it should have a, what is called, proper time at which each processes has to be completed, which, or rather, all the sub goals in forming the goals are being achieved at different stages, then and then only your complete analysis would be completed in a timely manner. And that is paramount importance, and correct, and what is current and the collected within an appropriate time frame. Otherwise, it is useless. Maybe the stale, because some another person might have done a particular research and your research would be what is called stale. That particular need to be always keep in mind. It should be complete. Whenever you are defining the objectives, then all the objectives with their sub objectives need to be properly defined, formulated in the form of the hypothesis which are necessary and what is called required, and thereafter the results would, what is called, would come, which is nothing but complete. Includes all the data you need to support your business decisions. Now, analyzing the research methodology, analyze and understand your research. That particular I already explained about that one. Keep your findings ready. That also I have discussed many times. Review and interpret the information to draw the conclusion. See, at each level of your research, you must actually review the processes, the time, as well as the what is called the data analysis, whatever are coming, and discuss with that, review that, interpret that, and whether that is coming to conclusions or not, or whether it requires some modifications in the processes which you follow may not be correct. The sample size what you, what is called, devise, it may not be correct. All such can be corrected upon in a timely manner and go ahead with that particular. And that's why review and interpretation is very much essential. Identify the main trends and the issues, opportunities, and the problem you observe. Keep track of the frequency with which each of the main, what is called, findings appears. I have discussed with this. Make a list of your finding with the most, what you can see, what is called, devising a particular report is an, what is called, science. I would call science, not art, because it should be in a manner which is clearly defined and following the rules and the procedures, whatever those are there, we, by virtue of which the audience would, what is called, get the, what your results, what is called, make and the findings in a manner understandable to them and can go upon and act upon and go ahead with their, what is called, the object for which they are using. Evaluate the list of the strength, SWOT analysis, always we do. Any of the, these things, we do a SWOT analysis. Prepare conclusions and recommendation about your research. Review your goals before making the conclusions. That is also we have discussed. Choose some strategies that will help you to improve. This also I have discussed before, so that I am not, what is called, wasting my time on that one. Now here, in a brief manner, I will discuss this research format. Because when you plan your research, you plan with all the types of the clients, what is called, requirements. And on the basis of that, you devise a plan, you devise the processes, devise what is called the objectives and the hypothesis, etc. And all this is nothing but to be given in a manner, what is called, which would be acceptable, understandable, as well as usable by your users. That is why the report format has to be in a proper manner. I have discarded so many types of the synopsis and what is called the thesis. when prepared, which are not on the basis of the what is called requirements. Otherwise, that format has to be properly depending upon the requirements of your what is called audience, or maybe your company, or whatever your thoughts. You have to redevise in this manner. That is, first of all, that should be abstract so that one can get an idea about what exactly you have done in a one or two pages. You can do that one. Define your what is called the introduction. What is the existing situation? What is the desired situation? And I am trying to build up by building up the variables and following the processes, defining the objectives, defining the hypothesis. And that is what I have done, and the process which I have followed, and the research methodology, everything that should come in the cases of your introduction also. And that should be clearly defined so that that particular would give an audience that yes, exactly what is the problem existing and what you want, that is the desired. And you are filling the gap between the two by properly devising the various independent variables and testing on such independent variable and finding out one which is very helpful to the audience. Third is about the review of literature. You must review the existing literature relating to your problem on hand so that the audience can come to know that yes, the research has already been done in relation to this, and that particularly also your part as far as the research report is concerned. Last but not least is data analysis, that the processes, your tables, your whatever the research which you have done, that interpretation as well as results, as well as the scope of limitations, as well as further scope as far as the study is concerned, that also should come in the cases of your research format. In other words, your report format should be in such a way, any of the university, whatever you what is not go, the basic structure of your report is this. And any university caters to the needs of the any type of the industry. Our CA Institute is no exception to that. Many of the directors of listed companies have become, you know, L&T director, maybe Dhaliwal Cement. So many listed companies directors have done research under me. And in the beginning, they were also not knowing what to do as far as the research is concerned. And after doing this research, they have realized that yes, their logistic problem has solved, these problems are solved, and all this type of a thing is nothing but your mind is structured toward defining a proper type of the research problem, built upon them the various alternatives which are seeking the solutions to your problem in a better and scientific manner. That thing is done by a way of research, which I am sure would help a practicing chartered accountant as well as those who are in the industry, whether they will pursue their career as a what is called a doctorate or not. But this will help definitely for the purposes of furtherance of their what is called job in a manner which is exactly what the your users or maybe the CEOs or maybe whatever those rank, and you have got upper these things. Because many of the industry people also, because I got very less academicians which are I'm training as a scholars, many are coming from the industry, chartered accountant as well as CEOs of the companies only, and they have benefited a lot as far as this type of the research. Whether you do research, pursue the research as a what is called doctorate degree or not is your choice, but definitely it will help to you in performing various types of the things which are there. I have given many things which are what is called discussed here. I will not what is called give more time more. These are the areas where the research can be done. Rule number one, see what is the problem. Rule number two, see the literature review, and in that case, see whether there is a standing operating procedure is there, whether there the rules and regulations are there, where the answer is already there. Then it cannot be a research area. It will not be a research problem. Forget about that. Follow such rules and go ahead. Only when you find that such rules, standing operating procedures, or the rules and maybe the notifications, or there are flaws, that can be the area of research. And once you have done that one, then that particular can be your. Whether this is a COVID situation where we require what is called work from home, then what is called going ahead with remote control as far as your accounting procedures and the process are concerned, the formulation of the techniques, or maybe the investment management, or maybe the capital budgeting decisions, or maybe the debt management, or maybe your clients are SME, and various schemes are being floated by the Maharashtra and our learned the Modi government. for the purposes of SMEs, and SMEs also can get a large amount of the benefit by virtue of our research, that how their procedures can be inbuilt and their SME sector can grow up to what is called a large scale company. That assistance we can give, provided we do a research into their problems. Their problems are not simple. SME sector is facing a huge type of the problem, not having accounting procedures, not having the proper types of the, you know, reporting formats, not having what is called ad hocism is always there, really less staff, not automate their systems as far as the accounting is concerned. So all these problems, we can have a research area and we can guide the SME sector to grow. That is what our Modi ji Sarkar is asking us, that our contribution of the chartered accountant is required to grow this system, grow this GDP, and have that particular, when it is possible, only when we have what called the SMEs will be elevated to a large sector. And our onerous job is there, that we should help the industry, we should help our clients to grow, not only to earn only the fees, but to what is called grow them further so that they can contribute to the GDP. And whatever the investment which is flowing from China and all other parts, and that particular would be properly what is called utilized, and our expertise would help the particular our country, our nation, as well as our state where we are operating in a better manner. I am not going to this illustrative areas of the topics, which is left to you for the purposes of dwelling. And our learned what is called the panel is consisting of a huge talent, and whatever the areas which I have not touched upon, they will touch upon, and we will have a fruitful discussion after this. I'm very thankful to Lalit ji that he has initiated a very good beginning as far as the research is concerned, which would help the nation building process by virtue of our chartered accountants contributing to this. My PhD was done at the age of 50. So anybody can do any type of the what you call, do anything at any point. One of my chartered accountant friend is now at the age 63-64. Still he is doing research because of the fact that he is going to get an EPL. I think this research has to be adopted as a what is called a career for the purposes of, you know, going ahead. And there are many stalwarts are there in the panel which will discuss about the formalized way in which you can do the research to a doctoral degree as far as this is concerned. I am very thankful to Vishal ji also that he coordinated with me the particular way, and you are their IT team, that they have done a wonderful job for the purposes of coordinating the panelists as well as me for the purposes of getting ourselves prepared for giving effective presentation. Whether that is done or not, I don't know, but I am very thankful to all of you and the WIC as well as ICI. I am also thankful to Vice Chairman of our ICI, Nihar ji, that he has what is called thought this, brought this idea of the research as being a paramount importance for the purposes of the chartered accountant fraternity. They are slowly and starting realizing the what is called our 83% of the audience. Now the statistics what is say that those who are enrolled, 83% of the audience, and that is more than what is called 1300 and 1400 are there, which are attending this session. That means they are aware about the importance of the research. Only I have the step before standing before you to give a knowledge about that. Thank you very much. Thanks for this. I am over to the organizers for the further what is called the things panel discussion. Thank you. Thank you.
I would like to take the opportunity to thank Dr. Subhash Desai,
who
gave us a wonderful session on a research topic in an hour. I think within an hour, given the time span, sir, you covered very well all the topics, starting from data collection, formulating the research question, and writing a research report, and also its utility to the industry and practitioners. So thank you very much on behalf of the entire WIRC team and also the audience. Thank you very
much. Thank you very much. I think panel discussion, before that introduction will be there, no? Vishal ji. Hello.
Subhash ji, Subhash ji, panel discussion introduction
discussion will be today.
Our regional council members are joining just.
Very good, very good.
Just a minute. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Lalit bhai.
આપણે જોઈન થયા છે ને પેલા
Yeah, friends, so I'll continue with this special task given to me of introducing the panelists for this panel discussion. To start with Sangeeta ji, she started her career as a chartered accountant in 1984. Her articles were published in the Journal of the Chamber of Tax Consultants and Outlook Money. She wrote two books relating to accounting and taxation published by the BCAS. Then she did a doctorate in management and joined academics. She is HOD of finance in Sydenham B School. She conducts sessions at other B schools of repute like JBIMS and XIMR. She has written research articles on varied topics in academic journals. She is invited by US universities as guest faculty. She was awarded the Dedicated Professor Award and Leadership in Education Award by World Education Congress. She is independent director, corporate trainer, mentor to entrepreneurs, trained counselor and life coach. She is actively involved in activities of ICI, BCAS, CII and BSE. She is part of the Committee of Management Accounting of ICI. Her recently conducted webinars on tips to happiness and success, role of independent directors and portfolio construction were highly appreciated by the participants. She passionately works for the cause of cancer and was felicitated by Tata Hospital. She works closely with various trusts and NGOs for the cause of financial inclusion. And she has to her credit almost 20 publications. Ma'am, we welcome you on this platform and also as a panelist. Friends, the next panelist is Dr. Paritosh Basu, who is a scholarly academician with a background of 34 years corporate experience, mainly in finance, strategic planning, and IT enablement functions. His last two corporate positions were that of the global group controller and CFO of two large MNCs of India. Presently, he is a full-time senior professor and chairperson of MBA Law of NMIMS University School of Business Management and engaged in several research and consulting activities. His current areas of research include professional skepticism, Industry 4.0, digital transformation, blockchain, and artificial intelligence. He is a fellow member of both the ICAI and the IC and the Institute of Cost Accountants of India and a life member of the Computer Society of India. He was awarded PhD degree by the Calcutta University in 1999. Dr. Basu is a digital evangelist. He is presently engaged in some startups as a senior advisor and helping them to develop solutions for digital transformation of businesses. He has chaired four World Blockchain and AI summits held in Moscow, Dubai, and India. He has authored three papers on blockchain amongst many of his research papers and presentations in national and international events. Presently, he is writing a monthly column on digital transformation in the Journal of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. Dr. Basu is an avid management trainer, mentor, and researcher, and he provides consulting services in areas of strategies, corporate transformation and restructuring, digital transformation, risks, and government management. His experience in MNC spans over a wide spectrum of covering major functional areas across continents and countries. Dr. Basu participates as a member of the Board of Directors, Committee of Chamber of Commerce, Advisory Boards of Startups, Board of Studies of UG and PG Programs of Academic Institutions, etc. With these words, I welcome Dr. Basu to this panel discussion, and we look forward to hear from him. Thank you. Friends, our third panelist, Professor Ketan Upadhyay. He has as his experience teaching at the postgraduate MCOM level for 20 years in the Department of Accounting and Financial Management, Faculty of Commerce, the Maharaja Sayajirao University of Baroda, Gujarat. He is also teaching at the undergraduate BCOM level for 28 years and recognized as a research guide. He is a visiting faculty at the BBA, PGDFM, PGDBM, Baroda branch of WRC of ICI, and Center for Entrepreneurship Development, Gandhinagar. As a corporate trainer, he trains at the Gujarat Training and Research Institute for the employees of Gujarat Urja Vikas Nigam Limited and the group companies in the area of accounting, costing, financial management, and project management. He has published various books, including Financial Management in Private Sector Banks, co-editor of Emerging Trends in Financial Reporting Standards, co-editor Paradigm Shift in Financial Reporting, and further he has published 22 articles and papers at reputed journals. He is a member of the editorial board Gujarat Journal of Commerce and Management, published by Knowledge Consortium of Gujarat, and also a government nominated member to the University Granth Nirman Board Gujarat. Presently he is the dean of the Faculty of Commerce at the MS University of Vadodara. And earlier, he was the head Department of Accounting and Financial Management, Associate Program Director, BBA program, and also a government nominated Senate members. With this, I welcome Professor Ketan Upadhyay to this panel discussion. Friends, last but not the least, a very dear friend of mine, CA Dr. Alok Shah. He is a chartered accountant and a member of the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. He has done his doctorate on the topic of problems of working capital management of selected pharmaceutical companies of Maharashtra state, and has also written a book on working capital management. He was the ex-associate professor in the Department of Accounting and Financial Management, Faculty of Commerce, MS University of Baroda for more than 24 years, and taught students at postgraduate MCOM for more than 12 years. Presently, he is practicing as a chartered accountant and is in charge senior partner of the firm CNK and Associates LLP, Vadodara. His other associations include being a managing committee member of the Vadodara Chamber of Commerce and Industry, committee member of the CII Central Gujarat Zone Finance and Economic Affairs Committee, ex-chairman of Vadodara Stock Services Limited, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of the Vadodara Stock Exchange Limited. And he was over there appointed by the SEBI as a public representative director and also a director of Hingorani Foundation. Alok Bhai has addressed several investor awareness campaign meetings of Vadodara Stock Exchange Limited, addressed several seminars and conferences in the areas of taxation, finance, accounting and auditing, company laws as Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, cost accountants and other professional forums. He is a visiting faculty at various courses of the MS University of Baroda, the ICI, the ICSI, ICWI, and other reputed institutions. With this, I welcome CA Dr. Alok Shah to this panel discussion, and I now hand over the proceedings to the moderator, CA Subhashbhai Desai. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Our today's panel discussion is methodology, scope, and dynamics. All the panelists, as we have understood from Vishalji, that all are very learned and very experienced people, and it is just by chance I am a moderator. I am going to ask some questions, but before that, let me very clear that now the time constraints are there, and that's why we all are going to look at the time constraint and thereafter frame our these things. All are very learned, and all each of them, if they stand on the floor, they can speak for six hours also. So I'm asking my first question to Dr. Basu, that what are your area, what are your thoughts as far as the research is concerned, that is what about the, you know, the processes, the comparison and everything. So that particular, first of all, show a highlight or other tell us the audience about that. Thank you, sir.
Okay, Dr. Deshai, thank you very much indeed. I am indeed grateful to the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, Western India Regional Council, for giving me this opportunity. I hardly get called from the Institute. Of course, I used to be the research committee member way back in 2011-12 and 12-13, when I'm forgetting the chairperson's name at that point of time. She used to be my chairperson of the research committee. After that, I have not been associated with the CA Institute much, but this is a very interesting opportunity for me to talk to you. I now remember Bhavna Ben. I think age is catching up. Bhavna Ben was the chairperson of the research committee. I used to be in the committee. Anyway, let me start my talk on it. I thought I will talk to you on three points. One is the point which Dr. Deshai has already asked me. The second point, I thought I will talk to you about the areas where one can do a lot of research, other than the areas which Dr. Deshai has already spoken. I have my specific areas to suggest to you. And the third one, if opportunity I get in terms of time, I will talk about what are the suggestions for institute. But I'm at the moment taking up the first question. Millions saw the apple falling and Newton asked why. That's the question which made me to get into research. The first thing one does research is for self-satisfaction, not publishing this research report. As long as you are not having the quest for learning, as long as you are not in search of excellence, you are not there for research. You are not a fit candidate to be researched. Let me give you three examples on three different time frames. Let me go back to the year in which I started my PhD, 1995, I was not allowed to get registration done unless and until I have done 1 year of full desktop research. And I was doing that at that point of time, diploma in management accountancy of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. I went to my professor and said, sir, I want to do a PhD on transfer pricing. As you know, I got my PhD degree in 1999. And transfer pricing is a subject came to Income Tax Act in 2001. He said, no research has been done in India. So how can you do research on transfer pricing? So he made me to work for one full year. And then he got convinced that I can do transfer pricing. Then I will take you back 2016-17. One fine morning, I got a mail from a professor of Macquarie University, Australia. He is a fourth generation Fiji-born Gujarati. His name is Chris Patel. And the mail was marked to one lady called Ying Sammy. Both of them were teaching in Macquarie University, Australia. And Chris asked me a simple, straightforward question. Professor, would you like to do a research with me on professional skepticism? And I was told that we are trying to understand whether skepticism is an important qualification a statutory auditor or an internal auditor should have. They have already done this research from the context of China and Australia by that point of time. They tried to understand whether the cultural influence or the traditional culture of a country and the civilization of a country has got any impact on the audit procedure conducted by an auditor. And believe me, he asked me that we are not going to do any work on any secondary data. We have to do work on primary data. You have to study not less than 150 chartered accountants of India who are engaged with the profession of auditing. I said, fine. Then he said that you have to give me a history of India on the accounting and auditing. Without understanding the history of auditing and accounting in India, I'm not going to accept what you are going to forward to me. So that made me to go back to Kautilya's Arthashastra.
And participants, as of now, I see there are 1,249 participants in this webinar here. Believe me, I have gone to 1500 BC. That means आज से 2555 साल पहले, we are on 2020, and 1500 BC means add 1500 to 2020. So 3520 years ago, one has tried to trace whether there were auditing and accounting in Indian civilization. And then I ended up researching out that in both Mahabharata and Ramayana, there are traces of accounting and there are traces of auditing. So the point I'm trying to ask you, drive home, that why I did this work, did I do for publication of any paper? Did I do for putting my name in some journal that such and such research has been done by Paritosh Basu? Answer is completely no. Answer is, when an opportunity came to me to understand human civilization, particularly in the civilization of India, I wanted to study Indian civilization. Similarly, when I did my PhD, how the topic came to my mind, like Dr. Desai talked about this selection of topic. I did my PhD on transfer pricing. I saw a fight between two general managers of two plants of our company when I used to work at that point of time in Bamalori. And in Bamalori, I found that the input maker is doing a jhagra with the output maker, that if I sell the product to you, I get so much of price. If I sell the product to outside, I get so much of price. Why should I sell it to my inside unit? So whenever you are doing a research, do a research on a live issue. That's why I started with the word, millions saw the apple falling, Newton asked why.
Very good.
Now, let me come back to my present research interest. After professional skepticism, my present research interest in the area of digital transformation. I've so far written 11 papers on this. Why I'm doing this? I'm trying to understand what is digital transformation. Friends, why the word I is coming time and again in my talk? Because I thought that after Desai spoke so much about research, perhaps a case study in the form of a member of your profession perhaps would help. So I recently did an MS form and circulated in LinkedIn. I have about 14,800 plus members in LinkedIn connection and about 1,340 in Twitter. I have administered the questionnaire at least 5 times to both the platforms. Will you believe I have got only 54 answers? And that too on a very interesting topic called digital transformation. There are only 16 questions, 14 of them are of MCQ type. Point I'm trying to drive home, I'll come back to you. I'll just take you to one of my discussion with the professor of London School of Economics, Professor Michael Bromwich.
Basu sir, I will give you more time afterwards also, because I think Ketan wants to add something. I think what is research, because your areas are wonderful. I mean, the topic, how you chose, etc. In the subsequent, again, I will give a time. Ketan wants to add something. I think we are on the basis of his this thing. Can you say something about or adds to something about the research and how that, as a chartered accountant, suppose presuming that I am not a doctorate, so how I should get myself enrolled as a doctoral program? Ketan, please.
You want me to answer that? I was trying to come to that little later.
Acha, okay, no problem. Now Ketan is going to add that one. Later on. We'll come to you. Yeah, sure.
Let Dr. Paritosh Basu go on. No issues. Let him continue with that. I don't mind.
Okay. I'll quickly come to that point only, which you are trying to understand, is that whenever one person selects a topics for research, whenever one person wants to solve a problem of the society, whenever one person wants to the body of knowledge, the first and foremost important criteria for him or her is to satisfy himself or herself.
Dr. Desai has spoken enough about how to conduct research, how to select your population. But I have a couple of points here, is that don't convert your research to a commodity. So research has to be identically different. So choose your problem which is uniquely bothering your industry. Next is my suggestion to anybody and everybody who is doing research, please do not do base your work mostly on secondary research. My suggestion, you go for your primary work, because the transfer pricing research which I did, Michael Bromwich told me, in India, if you have got 27 samples, you should be considering yourself happy, because less than 30 samples generally research doesn't accept. My another simple point is that do a predictive research. See, a lot of research have been done in India about what has happened in the past and trying to learn out of it. Recently, I'm doing a lot of studies on predictive research and ascension research. Ascension research and predictive research talks about how the world is going to look like 10 years hence and 20 years hence. So the ascension research is a very good contribution of CA professionals in India can do. In terms of ascension research, the research scholar would like to predict based on the trend in present and the development taking place all over the world, how the Indian economy is going to look like and how we can achieve a state of readiness in terms of our various regulatory provisions, in terms of your various accounting requirements, in terms of various risk management requirements and strategy formulation requirements. So I personally feel today an immense contribution can be done by a CA professional if an ascension research is done and a predictive research is done. And my personal suggestion to all of you is that do work on past data to know for the future, and learn from the mistake. But please do work which is going to be a foundational work, which is going to formulate policies and procedure and help us to make our work much more risk-enabled. Let us not be risk manager, let us be risk-enabled managers, because with VUCA, we have added two more words. One is fear of unknown and one is unprecedentedness.
So very good,
we
Dr.
have to
Basu.
Work for fear of unknown and yeah. fear of unprecedentedness.
Yes, yeah. Dr. Basu's suggestions are definitely going to help the chartered accountants in formulating the areas where they should go and what the type of the research. I think Ketan wants to add something. Ketan, please.
Yeah. Good afternoon, all esteemed panel members, Dr. Subhash ji, Dr. Sangeeta ji, Dr. Paritosh ji, my colleague, my friend Alok bhai, Vishal ji, Lalit ji. First of all, I thank you. I thank you and the esteemed great institution ICAI for making me part of you today. Just what Dr. Paritosh ji was talking, recently in the month of May 2020, I'm very happy to share with everybody here that the team led by a very senior chartered accountant, CA Manish Bakshi, and a team from Faculty of Commerce, MSU Institute of Baroda, they jointly made a good 50 pages work on what happened during this month of April and May. So what I want everybody to say that, you know, we as an accountant, we always talk about relevance. And this was a need of the hour. So Baroda branch, WIRC, led by Sri Manish Bakshi and other colleagues, Puran Kambat ji, we get together, we talked about it, and then we came out with a small piece of paper where, you know, we took into consideration different literature review. Somebody from us wrote on MSME, somebody spoke on us on a particular set of MSME, and some suggestions were made and were presented to the university. This is what I call that institute and university can greatly do a combined work, right? See, we have to be relevant in the sense that time requires today is that we have to stand together for the nation. Today, I would look at research in a very broad perspective and can we help government, state government, local government doing some work jointly, faculty, university and the institute, so that we can contribute towards, you know, some meaningful thing. Country, economy, industry, trade greatly needs us, greatly needs us. And I think this is the right time we should stand up to the time and do something little bit. Can I do something in Vadodara? Can we do something in Pune so that we can help our, you know, small traders and all? This is, I think, it also comes in the definition of research.
Shubhaji, I'll just add one more point, Ketan Bhai, what is saying. I'm trying to say that definitely we'll do contemporary research, but we have to do research for becoming future ready. Because yes, worldwide ascension analysis says that we are going to receive much more such unprecedented things coming in our way. So let's work for becoming future ready.
Absolutely. That is very true, sir.
Well,
and both of you have given a, you know, inspiration to many chartered accountants who are in a two-way mind, whether to go or not to go or something, and they will decide upon. With me, CA Sangeeta, she is there. And her specialization, I know that she is a very good, what is called, presenter of the, you know, research papers. Research paper is also one of the aspect of research. It's a mini type of the research thesis. So please highlight something more on this research report, I mean, what is called a research paper. Please, madam, that will help our members to write such type of the papers. Please, madam. Voice, madam.
At the outset, let me thank ICAI and WRC for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, Lalitji. And also congratulations, Subhash Bhai. Your presentation was excellent. Coming to the question about presentation of a research paper, let me tell you, the excitement starts in writing the paper. When you start writing the paper with some premise or some assumption in your mind, and then when you go through the literature review and you have your primary data collection, do the analysis, and you come to a conclusion and you realize it is something, maybe what you thought was right was wrong, and you come to a totally different conclusion. It's sort of, you know, it sort of brings a humility in you that you had a perception which may not be the right perception. And let me tell you, very often our perceptions are conditioned by our environment, maybe by our parents, by our siblings, our friends, colleagues, bosses, or whatever we hear in the media and all. And research makes us come to the pure truth, which is very, very exciting, I feel. And to carry on the trend, what everybody is saying about contribution to the nation and all, definitely at a macro level, today it's all collaboration, all research papers. See, somebody else is doing a research paper for secondary data, they are going to read our paper. So it's a collaborative effort. Finally, at a macro level, you are contributing to society a lot. At your organization level, when you have a research bent of mind, you don't take decisions just on financial figures. Like suppose you go for CapEx, it is not only by NPV analysis. You will go deeper into the analysis by research and find out through primary data and secondary data and come to a conclusion. So that really helps. So it will impact your bottom line also and your performance in the business organization. And as a person, you develop. Because then, see, we all chartered accountants by our very nature are hardworking. We are diligent. But then this gives us a direction and we get a deeper understanding of a topic, I think.
Right. Very good, ma'am. And that will really guide the chartered accountants how to write that particular type of the, you know, research paper and present it. I think, Dr.
I generally start writing a research paper first through literature review only. I collect much information as I can. From the various journals, articles, which is the latest last 2-3 years. And then I prepare a table of the what is the gist of that article and what further I would require to know, which is not there in the article. So then I prepare the table as you had suggested of dependent variable, independent variable, and sometimes add moderating variable also. So once I know the variables which I want to work on, Based on that, I prepare the questionnaire and then send it or take interviews and then analyze it using statistical tools. And one doesn't have to have a mental block about statistical tools, because as you said today, Excel also has a lot of facilities there. And even on the net, you have many tools available, software freely available, where you can feed in your data and you get your analysis. Excellent. And then you have your conclusion and findings. And it is exciting when you start with something and you end with something else.
Absolutely. And that is meaningful and understandable to all. Very nice, sir, ma'am. I think I should turn to Alok for what are actually the, because I left that particular areas for the research as a chartered accountant, whether in practice or industry is concerned. Dr. Basu has started with that and guided us how that particular research type he should undertake. But I think you should throw the light. What are the various areas where a chartered accountant can pursue his career as a doctorate? Please, Alok, sir.
Good afternoon. At the outset, I thank all of you, more specifically Vishal Doshi, Mr. Desai, and Ketan, my colleague, and my other co-panel speaker, Madam Sangeeta and Paritoshi. Thank you, sir, for asking my view. I personally feel that being a chartered accountant and going into the research area, we can explore many areas which are correlated and related to what we have already studied or what we practice day in and day out. It can be a financial accounting, it can be a management accounting, it can be a working capital, which is a very core area in the financial management. It can be auditing, it can be a recent practices in the auditing, it can be a forensic accounting, it can be a capital market, it can be mergers and acquisitions, it can be a taxation, it can be international taxation, it can be corporate governance, it can be treasury management, it can be an insurance. So basically there are wide spectrum of areas even within this broad area as well. In fact, you know, there is a plethora of information available, some part of which I think even Ketan can also share, because he has, I think, the PowerPoint presentation available. But you know, having done my PhD on the working capital management, and very recently having discussed with a lot of people, I feel that those informations from where you are, you can get those information. Some part which even Madam also said, that one can start with the review of literature. Even Nihar Bhai, who is a vice president of the institute, even he said that we need to start with reading the books. Instead of just Googling out everything, we need to start reading the book. The basic thing one need to look at before starting, in fact, or before plunging into the research activity. Thank you.
Sir Alokji, whether it is possible to have a research in auditing? What are your views about auditing in the areas of please?
I think very, very aptly, Mr. Basu was also mentioning about the professional skepticism, which is basically a very relevant area in the auditing. In fact, there are new methodology which are going to emerge. More specifically, like when we talk about recent changes where we are working from home or we are in the digital accounting, the digital auditing is also going to come. There are auditing in the, you know, very typical scenario, like when we are talking about a blockchain company or basically the technology company, or there are new startups which are coming, you know. So basically as an auditor also, our perception, our methodology is required to change. And this research is going to help us to derive the new techniques, the new methodology, the new way of looking the old things. And I think that is what all about the research, what I have understood over all these 25, 30 years of my practice as a chartered accountant.
Very good.
Subhash, I want to make a point is that aspect in the organization, whether it is your capital structure, whether it is your capex, whether it is your working capital management, if the decisions are taken based on research, and where chartered accountants can be of great help because they have the technical expertise, and if they use the research skills of collection of primary data, secondary data, and analyzing it, the decision is bound to be far more superior, and mitigation of risk of the organization and increasing the bottom line of the organization.
Absolutely. Because nowadays, the risk analysis is only the paramount things wherever, whichever the areas are there. Thanks, Alok.
That,
tell me.
lot of job opportunities because of that. If you have a research bent of mind, there's definitely going to be more job opportunities.
Absolutely. Basuji, you are left with...
Dr. Deshai, I have identified certain areas of research.
Tell
so
me,
if
sir,
I may list them out one by one.
Absolutely,
my
sir.
My first that area is professional skepticism. And if you give me permission, I'll elaborate it later.
Elaborate.
Because I have worked on it. Second is simplification of certain accounting standard, particularly the accounting standard for financial instruments. A research is required to be conducted in India about the applications of accounting standard on financial instruments, whether all those critical provisions of that standard is really needed and applied in India. My second, third point is central bank digital currency. CBDC, it is one subject on which I'm researching quite a lot, and this morning also I've done a tweet. Worldwide, a lot of digital currency are cropping up, including Libra. But I personally feel CBDC is an essential, and in two years before in Delhi University's blockchain conference, I spoke about it. Cryptocurrency in the hands of private players should not be allowed. CBDC has to come. So chartered accountants must work on CBDC. My next area of research is robotic process automation of ledger scrutiny and certain investigation which are possible to be done by RPA process in the financial data analysis. The third area is blockchain-based auditing. Let me tell you, PwC and Ernst & Young have already come with two solutions, but those solutions even today are not complete. Next is implementation of Ind AS in the matter of corporate governance. You must have read those famous two papers of Mr. Jain, where it has said that IFRS and Ind AS are going to improve corporate governance in India. I must say that we should do a post Ind AS and pre-Ind AS study and see whether qualitatively there is an improvement in corporate governance between these two areas. That's a very interesting area of study. The next is whether in this, so much of disclosure in this has helped other than the promoters, rest of the stakeholders to improve their business decision management. Because I personally feel in this has made us to disclose much more things. 2008, I spoke in NDTV about IFRS, because in 2008, I have converted 247 companies to IFRS. So that point of time, we predicted that IFRS and Ind AS is going to improve the standard of corporate governance in India. I need to understand through my research whether it should be done. Next is there should be a definite immediate requirement of a research by Indian Institute of Chartered Accountants. What should be the code of conduct for shared CFO services, because shared CFO services is becoming an order of the day, and it is a must for MSMEs who cannot afford a full-fledged CFO. Yet at the same time, they need quality services around the area of a CFO's functional area. Next area of research is emotional intelligence. Importance of emotional intelligence for accounting profession, treasury profession, internal audit, and statutory audit. As you know, the world is becoming more and more sensitive, and it is becoming psychopathic in terms of fear of unknown. COVID-19 has created a lot of depressing situations in the minds of people. Emotional intelligence has become one of the most important points. That's why, despite a lot of resistance, in MBA law program of NMIMS, I have introduced as a chairperson emotional intelligence as a 100 marks paper. So every finance professional to know about emotional intelligence. Next point is communication skills. We need to understand by going firm after firms, auditors after auditors, we need to have one firm has to have one observer about the communication skill of the team members. We need to identify what are the underlying areas of problems in communication skill, because I have seen in my life, I have worked with more than 200 to 300 professionals all around the world in finance profession in my 34 years of career. One thing we badly need, particularly we Indians badly need, is communication skill. Communication skill in the context of not only speaking but also listening. Communication skill in the context of emotional intelligence and organizational behavior. Another very important point is to understand is alignment of a corporate's vision and mission with the financial objectives of a corporate. I'm all talking about foundational research. Believe me, I believe in foundational research. That's why these days I'm working on a lot of ascension analysis. My next paper is going to be Digital Transformation of Agriculture of India. So why I'm working on digital transformation? Because we the chartered accountants have the responsibility to make India future ready. And today what is happening, it's happening. We will be definitely surviving. Surviving and revival is also important, but after revival, there is a stage called prosperity. And we want to be one of the best in the Committee of Nations of the world. So we have to become future ready. So we must have to identify what should be our research areas for chartered accountants, because we call ourselves nation builders.
Very good.
Next,
very good.
Another very interesting area of research should be economic value addition. That is the area of value destruction. Minimization of value destruction is one of the most important functions of a CFO. We must know, we must research what are the areas where value destruction is taking place in India.
Very good, sir. Dr. Basu, I think Ketan wants to add something. Ketan, please tell me.
Yes, sir. There is one more area.
Go back to yours.
Dr. Basu has given a lot of input to me to work hard next 10 years.
To all of us. Yeah, very good, sir.
Yeah. One more area I would like to pinpoint is that behavioral finance. This area is getting momentum these days. But the fun in this area is that we need to have a good professional and a good psychologist together, working together. You know, because behavior is a matter of psychologist who is studying the behavior of the people. But how the investors, companies, you know, different business model will behave in recent times, that is going to be an interesting area for us to study. So, but see, our university, all universities for that matter, they have a concept of co-guide. That means a student is working under two guides, the principal guide and a co-guide. So we are working here that somebody will take the help of, you know, psychologists to study the behavior, because we as a chartered accountant may not have a, you know, scientific knowledge of behavior, but a co-guide can help us in this matter. So, but behavioral finance is an emerging area, sir.
Yeah, I think Sangeeta wants to add something. Yeah, Sangeeta, thereafter you can.
The beauty of research, I've unmuted myself. Okay, the beauty of research is that it is gender neutral. It's males and females both can do it equally good. It is economic status neutral. Today, with so much of information available on the net, from any strata of society, you are poor, lower middle class, rich, it doesn't matter. Age, of course, we have seen is not the criteria. You can be in your youth, you can be middle age, even old age, most senior citizen also. So that is the beauty of research also. And let me tell you, it is language neutral also. You need not have a mastery over English, which where most of our communications is in. You can be very, very comfortable in your regional language also and do research and then get it translated in the English language also. So that is the beauty of research, I would say. And also, suppose somebody from the audience wants to do research and has a topic in mind. They say, what is the relevance of this research as such? What Dr. Basu said, it need not be published or something. You are doing it for your own value addition. You're doing it for your own understanding. And when you go on collecting data, your secondary data, it sort of develops a love for reading, a love for information in you, and you are slowly grooming yourself and becoming a better person. And this research findings you can definitely share with ICAI research committee people who may get it, you know, refined and get it published in some newsletter or journal of ICAI. You can show it to your boss, who may show it to your clients, and it may be useful for them in business decision making. Okay,
right, very good. Alok, you want to add something or I want to ask you one question?
I'll just add to Dr. Ketan, Professor Ketan's point, very simple point. I have taught the subject behavioral finance couple of years in my institute. Let me tell you two things you should be careful about. One is heuristics and the doctrine of limited rational. So heuristics, doctrine of limited rational and behavior, one has to be made very, very careful. And all this taken together brings in the subject of financial objectivity, because finance is a practical subject, it's a tangible subject. So unless our financial objectivity are seen with behavioral finance, are seen with emotional intelligence, are seen with the alignment and vision, mission of the company, are seen with the stakeholders' experience management, not only customers' experience, but I call it XRCSM, stakeholder relationship management, we are going to fail in future. So I'll talk about professional skepticism later if you give me some time, 2-3 minutes.
Definitely, we'll have time. Alok, do you want to add something or I want to ask you one more question?
I want to just supplement what Sangeeta madam was trying to suggest.
Tell me.
As a chartered accountant, we are very aptly placed while taking up the research. And in fact, day in and day out within our own office as a practicing chartered accountant or while working, we are doing that research, sometime even unknowingly, like, you know, preparing a case study for the client, for giving an advice, or maybe when there is some merger acquisition is coming. So I want to tell you all the you know, participants at large, that basically the research is inbuilt in our curriculum. It is inbuilt with the chartered accountant per se, and we are doing it day in and day out. Even, you know, while advising the client on a particular treatment under the accounting standard, whether it is an Ind AS implementation. So we are doing this basically, you know, very, very regularly. It is only that love or the you know, that passion is to be developed, and that can start with the reading of the literature, what madam was trying to describe and what Mr. Basu was saying, and something I think even Ketan has something where he can go through very quickly on how the entire research methodology can done. I don't know how much time he will require, but my personal view is that basically in all, as a chartered accountant, because the large audience are of the chartered accountant, my suggestion to them is basically they can take up the research, they can write the articles, they can write research article very easily without any hesitation. It is not something which is a you know, rocket science. That is what is my personal view.
Absolutely, that was my question and you gave me the answer. Very good, sir. That is the telepathy. And now I will go to Ketanji. See, we have now unknown to us that yes, a chartered accountant, when he bent up his mind that yes, he has to go to the do a degree as far as the doctorate is concerned. So how he should go for? Any idea or any guidance you can give to the chartered accountant that suppose they want to enroll for the program, then how to go for that? Please tell, sir.
Sir, give me time to show my presentation. I would be talking my university specific, but every university has their own set of rules.
Ketan,
as I understand, most of the universities have the similar rules. Logically, what you are going to talk, it will help in general to all the chartered accountant or the researcher, the future researcher. I think you can quickly go through it so that it can also save the time.
Yeah, this is a UGC prescribed, you know, we are all governed under UGC scheme, University Grant Commission scheme. So by and large, every university will have this eligibility criteria. You know, you need a master's degree or a professional degree, which is declared equivalent to master's degree by corresponding statutory. I think ICAI is a statutory regulatory body, and is equivalent to master degree, where you need, in percentage are not given there, but 55% or grade D in case of grading system. If the candidate is from SC, ST or SCBC reserve category, then there is a relaxation of 5% from 55% to 50%. And there is a duration of registration, minimum 3 years, maximum 6 years, you can complete your PhD. Next. These days, there is another mechanism rolled out by with the guidance of University Grant Commission, that is called PET. It is called PhD entrance test. Now, if you want to enter into doctorate program of the university, then you have to either enter through PET. If you have cleared NET, NET is a national eligibility test, or SET. SET means state eligibility test, right? Junior research fellowship test. So if you have passed this type of test, those who are attached to the university system, they know what is NET and SET. It is a qualifying examination for becoming an assistant professor in the university setup. So if you have cleared your NET or SET, you need not appear for the PET. But if a chartered accountant is willing to come for doctoral program, then he or she has to enter, go for the PET. You can see that there are two stages of admission. One is entrance test with qualifying 50% marks, and second is interview or viva voce. So this is a general admission procedure into a PhD program. Thank you.
Thank you. Very good, sir. Anything more you want to add, sir? Or I'll go to Basu, sir. Basu, sir, you wanted to add something.
Yeah, in terms of research point, I have three more points to add. One very interesting thing which comes in the context of behavioral science, emotional intelligence, and heuristics. Social media evidences, whether those can be considered as an evidence for audit, that's an important area of research which one has to do. So these days, HR profession has started analyzing people and recruiting people by visiting their website. Similarly, various other analyses of website-based data can be done without even getting into the personal data and privacy issues of a person, and whether those can be considered as an evidence for audit, that's a very important point one has to understand. A next very interesting point I would like to come to is the skepticism point. We Indians are gurukul people, or we obey our seniors, whereas in American society or European society, they are independent thinkers right from the age of 18. They don't want to be guided. They want to be independent on their own. So worldwide, a new trend has come in auditing, that in a statutory audit team or an internal audit team, forensic audit team, a professional from one single civilization cannot come. That means, suppose this is a team of four people in America, one should be Chinese, one should be from Asia, one should be from, say, Latin America, or one should be from Europe. Why this is so? This is so because my research on Indian statutory auditors, which I have conducted along with two professors of Macquarie University, Australia, it has proved that in the auditing system, the way the world is getting complex today, the world is getting coupled with the world today, the way frauds are occurring, the way technology is developing, there has to be a definitive skill for understanding the impact of societal issue, impact of civilization issue, impact of cultural issue on finance profession. Let me tell you, I have gone through the first book of History of Indian Accounting by Professor G.D. Bose, the first president of Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Is my information correct? He has written a book on the history of accounting in India. And he has gone up to the age of Kautilya Arthashastra. If you go beyond that, Kautilya's Arthashastra, and go to the days of Ramayana and Mahabharata, I'm talking about 3,500 years before, you will find that India, one of the most rich nations and civilization in terms of its acumen in finance. At least I have written a paper and sent to my Australian scholars with whom I am doing this research. This research we are going for 3 years. It is not a PhD research. That is the message I'm going to convey to my editor participants here, that being a chartered accountant, if I feel that I am not a student, I'm not going to succeed. So Dr. Deshai, what I'm trying to pass on through this platform, that forget that you are a chartered accountant, forget that you are a practicing accountant, forget that you are a professional in a corporate house, believe that you are a student. I did my PhD when I was 45 years old with my child and with my wife sleeping in the bed, and I'm doing my work midnight. And our time when we started, we didn't have any computer with us. Our 45-page desktop survey paper was flooded by reading by my professor. So that's the mindset. Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has to work towards creating a mindset for research. Rest of the things will automatically follow. Millions saw the apple falling, Newton asked why. That's the culture where we have to bring in. Sir, I have certain suggestions for you in future. What should the institute work for? I'll just end up with one point now. At the base, the company should introduce case studies. As professors of MBA schools, we do not get a single case study published by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, which can take it to classroom. Within another 7 days' time, me and a professor of IIM Kozhikode, we are submitting a case study on a business family of Surat. A business family of Surat, they are 32 years business case study. We are putting it and transforming the organization to digital world. That is the basis of our case study. So Dr. Deshai, my recommendation to you, through you to the committee, that start with a case study at least.
Absolutely.
So that I take this case study to my classroom and teach my MBA students and say that here are contributions from your CA friends.
Your dream is going to come true, sir, definitely. Lalitji is there, definitely we'll think and say, yes, it will be doing. Sangeeta wants to add something.
I have certain recommendations which I'll come back to you later.
Yes, yes. Sangeeta.
I just wanted to make one point that I'm interacting with students all the time, and my students are all 30, 35 plus in that age group, but far junior to me. So there is a big generation gap. I mean, they are born in an era after License Raj. They are born in an era where some of them have skipped computers direct into smartphones. So, I mean, they are very comfortable on Excel sheets and all on smartphones also. So they're very, very tech savvy. And for them, social media is a given thing. Right from the age of 1 and 2, they are seeing their parents on social media. So they are of a different generation. Their skill sets are different. Their way of thinking is different. So maybe we need next time somebody below 30 on our panel to give us a different
perspective. All we are out on
so. And
Dr. Pandit, can I do a rejoinder? Can I do a rejoinder? Please permit me. I started with writing accounts in pencil when I was a CA article clerk. Today, if you search Google and put their patents, stop Dr. Stop Parito Stop Basu, you will find a filing by the World Intellectual Property Organization, Switzerland, about an invention in IT done by me as the principal inventor, which was supposed to be patented and cleared by WIPO. So the age gap and generation gap, which you are talking about, I started writing books with pen and pencil, and I ended up generating an artificial software engine against
that
which I have defended 18 prior arts. Writing pen and pencil to creating a software engine for conversion from any accounting standard to IFRS or IFRS to any accounting standard. And I'm not talking on here. You can search me in Google. I have defended 18 prior arts. Why I have done it, sir? For myself. So a chartered accountant has to satisfy himself for the contribution he is making. And that is against without any money. Your contribution is your satisfaction. Then only it will get added to the world of body of knowledge.
Very good, sir. Now I want to ask Ketan one question, sir. Now I am determined. I have taken admission. Chartered accountant has taken admission. Now he wants to go and start collecting the data. He wants to fund it also. Yes, UVC is one of the funding agency. But relating to that, how he should get the data? That is one question number one. And suppose he wants to go for the funding. Then how what are the various sources which are there for funding?
Please, sir, permit me to share the screen with you, sir.
Sure, definitely go through.
Dr. Deshai, I hope you are not finding me too much emotional with the topic.
Absolutely not, sir. Absolutely. We are emotional, sir. But you are adaptable. That is a very good thing. Good, sir.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Sir, my submission to the August gathering is that we have number of sources available in terms of, you know, magazines and newspaper, electronic database, books, journals, conference paper, thesis, encyclopedia, research report. We are basically looking for either primary data, which are to
just to interrupt Ketan, many of these informations are available freely without any cost, just to share with the audience. Yeah,
absolutely fine. But there are paid database also, Alok Bhai.
Yeah.
So basically, there are e-platform which are useful for literature review. As Dr. Sangeeta was emphasizing on literature review, so you can find a list of many, you know, authenticated platform like EPG Parsala, Swayam, Vidyamitra, Sodh Ganga. I would particularly like to tell all the aspirants for PhD that Sodh Ganga is a platform where every PhD scholar has to post his PhD for 1 month after the declaration of his result. And it is open for public comment. It is open for public comment. So my advice to all PhD aspirant friends that find out what type of research is particularly in area of accounting, finance have happened during last many years. You can find data of many years, which you will find on Sodh Ganga. Similarly, directory of open access journal. There is a UGC approved list of journal. There is a public library of sciences. National Digital Library is doing wonderful work to create awareness about library. There is a Google Scholar. There is Open Knowledge Gateway. The recent generation, current generation is very lucky that they have this type of, you know, sea of platforms available. There are available resources for data collection and literature review, Business Source Premium, Capital Line, Economic Output, India Stat, Industry Outlook, Progress Management, ProVES, CMI. I would like to draw your attention that Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, CMI, has a very good database in the name of ProVES, but it is a paid database. Taxman these days has also created a good database. E-Sodh Sindhu. Government of India is doing fantastic to, you know, create awareness about the researchers. Cambridge University Press, EPW, Emerald, JSTOR, Oxford University Press, Science Direct, Springer, Willick. I take pride that my university is doing wonderful. You know, Hansa Mehta Library in Vadodara is Asia's biggest library, and our librarian is doing wonderful job to help us in you know, literature review and data collection.
Good, sir. Very good, sir. Now the last question.
I would also like to add here, I mean, you can see on the screen that these are the top 10 accounting journals available, Journal of Finance, Review of Financial Studies. Then there are, next, there are top accounting journals global.
Right.
Yeah, just give me a minute. There are other sources also. You can go to, you know, sources of Ministry of Finance, Reserve Bank of India, IRDA, SEBI, AMFI, Association of Mutual Fund Industry, International Level, International Monetary Fund, you know, then World Bank. There are so authenticated data available. open knowledge repository. Yeah, so you can see that there are number of platforms available for the researchers to collect data for review of literature. I would also like to show you there's some open access resources, directory of open access journal, directory of open access repositories, directory of open access books. So for researcher, data and review of literature is not a hurdle these days as compared to our previous time where limited resources were available.
Good, sir.
So I Good, hope sir. That I have answered question number one, sir.
And number two now, funding.
Yeah. Number two now, funding. As far as funding is concerned, sir, you know, fundings are available basically for government projects, non-governmental projects, international agency funded, and company projects. There are councils, research council, government engineer agencies, charity organizations, NGOs. They are generally as a funding agencies. There are scholarships available. Those aspirants who are planning to go for research, there are fundings available, scholarship available from university grant commission, ICCSR means Indian Council of Social Science Research. Then, as I said, if you want to become a teacher, then you have to pass the examination called NET. NET means National Eligibility Test. JRF means Junior Research Fellowship. So these students are paid handsome amount to the extent of 30 to 50,000 rupees fellowship are paid by UGC to carry out research in the social sciences as well as physical sciences.
Very good.
ICSSR in social sciences giving postdoctoral fellowship, postdoctoral fellowship, senior fellowship, national fellowship. MHRD is also doing great amount of funding to the student. TIFR, that is Tata Institute of Fundamental UGC. Sir, I want to submit here that government is doing its best to get research ecosystem in the country. I'm just giving a few. I do not know whether time is available to me or not, but I have prepared a good material on, there are national fellowships available, there are senior fellowships available, there are doctoral fellowships available to PhD scholars. And there are, the website's detail are also given to you. You can see that.
Good.
We are also encouraged to go for, we in the university system, we are also encouraged to go for major and minor research. You can see that we can continue from 12 months to 24 months with a budget of 15 to 50 lakhs. Right, so major minor research project can be done. So and they, you can also have your staff, project staff, you can acquire, you can also go for research associate, research assistant, field investigator. So again, I'm telling that government, university system, UGC are very much there to help the aspirant researchers.
Very good, sir. Now, last question I want to ask Alok, and thereafter, yes, 10 seconds to summarize everybody so that we have got a paucity of time, so that the questions, if comes, then we will be able to answer that one. That is my purpose. Alok, yeah. All the panelists, including me, have stressed upon the data analysis. Now, the data analysis requires a background of whatever called statistics. What is your view about the statistics, whether a chartered accountant should have a very good knowledge about the statistics or not? Because I was afraid when I started my career as a PhD. So whether that is a sense or not sense, please say. Alok.
Very interestingly, even when I was pursuing my PhD, at that point in time also the computer I just started using almost before 17, 18 years back. So at that point in time, in fact, not having continuous knowledge of the statistics, I was considering that it might become hurdle for completing my PhD thesis. But believe me, I want to talk more to the, you know, the participants, that the basic understanding of the statistics is necessary. Because whenever you are doing a research, you are going to make analysis, you are going to use ratios, you are going to use the graphs, which are the basic thing. Over and above that, the standard deviation, the regression, the variance analysis. So in my personal opinion, statistics, again, which is a part of the curriculum in any case, as a chartered accountant when we pass out. So you will have to rebrush those things. And these statistical tools are required to be used to make your research more relevant, and you will be able to arrive at a better judgment. That is what is my personal view so far as the use of these statistical tools are concerned. And all these tools are available now under the Excel tool or under the graphs, and they are very, very, very user friendly. It again do not require that you will have to study for months and then you will be able to understand it. You will have to rebrush again, and then you can use it for your conclusion also while carrying out the research.
Very good. Thank you very much. And all the panelists have thrown upon a light and supplemented to my submission that yes, this chartered accountant should go for this career. I'm giving you one minute to each one of you. Why? Because we have got a time constraint, and that's why only one minute. Right. To summarize whatever you want to say, please time by this one. Thereafter, the particular question and answers, if there are any questions, and thereafter we will turn our mic to the organizers. Please, I'll start with Dr. Basu.
Dr. Deshai, I leave it to the audience to ask me questions, but they can also ask me questions through LinkedIn platform or Twitter platform. But here I want to give certain suggestions to the institute. The first suggestion is that if the suggestions are common and already implemented, those can be ignored. I suggest that institute creates a research fund, and it need not be necessarily a PhD research fund. The institute should conduct at least biannual research paper contribution competition and give the best researcher award, as we give the best chartered accountants award. Then the institute can think of introducing a research paper as an optional elective paper for the CA curriculum. What I mean, that in our MBA law, there is a paper which is by itself a research paper, double credit, 6 credit paper, and it has to be, it will be considered for their passing and score of the marks. Then the institute should introduce a case study competition, because in MBA classes, we do not get a single case study published by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. As you know, case study can already be marked.
Time is coming to end. Yeah. Sorry, Sarah.
Last one point. Let me tell you, if institute promotes case studies, like one of my case studies is being taught in Herbert School these days. I would say it's a Richard Ivey Business School case study. The institute's name will come up. Let us start with case study before the research paper.
Very good, sir. Now, Ketanji?
I'm just Ketan. Very happy that, I'm very happy that institute has taken a step of encouraging research among the, because it will really lead to a meaningful work in the country.
Right. Very good, sir. Anything more, sir?
No, sir. I just wanted to say that research is a very meticulous work required. So you have to have a research problem identified first of all, because identification of research problem is a crux, and then the research design. So I think research methodology itself should be a subject in the chartered accountancy syllabus if it is possible.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, Ketan. Now, Sangeeta, please, 1 minute.
Okay, I would like to share with the audience that I feel that the most important things in life cannot be taught. Your concepts become very clear when you take up a topic and do research on it. Like, I wrote a paper on robotic advisors, where robots are used to generate portfolio construction for retail investors. So when I did research on that, and of course I was under some assumption, and I reached another conclusion, which I said is quite an exciting part of the research. But then my concept of the efficient frontier became so clear. Like I had read it so many times, and every time I had to reread before speaking about it. But now I can just go and talk about it because I went deep and deep into that topic. So I think research helps you to make the bring about complete clarity about a concept.
Very good, madam. Very good. And last, Dr. Alok ji.
No, I think I have already talked about the chartered accountant's role in the research. So I think the question what you have put forward is already answered by me. I have given my view on that.
Thank you, sir. Very good. I am very thankful to Lalit ji that this particular type of the discussion is initiated to a topic which was untouched. I think in my 34 years of practice, I have never seen a seminar like this. So we are very happy that this is a very important topic, and a learned fellow like Dr. Basu, Sangeeta, thereafter Upadhyay ji, Alok ji, all of them have participated and shared their knowledge is definitely a wonderful thing. And the chartered accountants would, what is called, definitely ask for the furtherance, as because they are going to benefit in the practicing as well as their industry career. And the learned fellow has already shared that one. Lalit ji, I am very thankful to you and your team for the purposes of doing this wonderful idea. And because I am not seeing any questions, so I am transferring this particular to you for the further things. Thank you, sir.
Mishra ji, if there are any questions, please put them on the screen. Mishra ji.
Hello. Yes, sir.
Mishra ji, are there any questions?
I think Lalit ji, everybody is happy. Acha, okay, there are questions. I'm turning this to the panelists. How to know which analysis tools to be used? Because all the questions we may not take because of the paucity of time. But yes, question wise, I'm going. How to know which analysis tool to be used? If CA do not know much in the ANOVA, chi-square, and which have not been used any time during the practical world. In very brief, Basu ji, aapka highlight karenge. Because he is not aware about the statistical tool, and he is what is called want to use that particular tool. How he should go? Very 1 minute.
It is dependent upon the data volume you are getting, the hypothesis you have drafted. Is it a null hypothesis, or is it you are studying on the context of the dependent variable? Is it in the context of independent variable? But one point I must request the participant who has asked this question, which Alok ji has also highlighted, that you have to yourself know what are the statistical tools you can apply. And being a researcher, it should be your judgment which you should apply. Like the data which you have gathered, the source of the data you have gathered. So there is no one straight jacketed action or one size fit all kind of an answer for this. That is what my view is. Dr. Alok Shah can throw some light on this.
Anybody you want to throw more light on that? Because the second question is linked to first question only. Second question is linked to first, so that you can combine that one. How do you get a hypothesis? There can be fallacies in some your own theory, as you may be biased and you may not have even be aware. Is the hypothesis an iterative process to arrive at a researchable one? I think on this we can give 3 hours lecture. Only way within 1 minute, yes. I can tell you that all the objectives cannot be turned into hypothesis because of the fact of the quality of that data. What is a hypothesis is nothing but what you want to prove, and consists of two parts. One is null hypothesis and alternative hypothesis. In a statistical terms, we need to frame, and that is useful for designing the questionnaire and getting the results. What I reiterated in my particular session, I think this is very big question. That's why very difficult to answer. Third question I will just put in.
Sangeeta madam, hello, Subhash ji. Sangeeta wants to speak. Madam, please.
Sangeeta, please tell. Sorry, Sangeeta.
This may help a bit. But if you are disciplined and follow the process of the format of introduction, statement of problem, need for research, literature review, the table of variables, your research methodology, then your analysis, and finally your findings and conclusion. If you follow disciplined way, step by step the process, maybe it will become easier.
Absolutely. Anybody, analyst, anybody wants to add?
Ketan bhai, can you add something to this?
Yeah, I think before we go to hypothesis, there is a concept called working hypothesis. So you have to always mull over your research problem, the area of problem you want to study. You have to always mull it over a period of time, and then first work out a working hypothesis, review literature, and again you think about it. Then you, after considering maturely, you go to the real hypothesis. This is what is happens in the educational institutions.
Yeah, right. Anybody wants to add?
Dr. Deshai, can I take question number 4?
Question number 4, go. No problem. In a safe, I will just read out the question. Is it safe to assume that the research is not CS cup of tea? And this is a very important question, as CS possess only basic knowledge of statistics. I think Alok has highlighted that. CA don't have knowledge of high level of statistics, which is not needed, and that statistical tools are very complex. I don't think so. Also, the CA researchers are hardly equipped to understand the research tools. Sir, please answer.
I personally feel that if a student of CA like me can do a PhD, any CA can do a PhD, point number one. Point number two, if anybody is under the misgiven idea that very high level complex statistical tools are required to be known first and then research is to be done,
no,
that's also a misgiving idea. Today lots of tools are available which prescribes how to prepare your data and feed into that statistical tool. The tool itself will give you the result. So that because you do not know the tool cannot be an excuse or an alibi for you to not conduct a research. Point number one, you should be knowing in your heart of heart whether you have a problem which is bothering you, whether you want to find a solution to it, whether you want to add body of knowledge to the world of professionals, whether you want to create a footprint in the sands of time. Statistical tool will not be an impediment for you to do a authentic research work. That is for sure my assurance to you, whosoever has raised this question.
Anybody else wants to add?
Yeah, I want to say something. Can I say something?
Sangeeta, yeah, sure, ma'am.
I'll tell you that when I write my name, I don't use the word doctor. It is always CA Sangeeta Pandit. And where it's required to use, I will say CA Dr. Sangeeta Pandit. CA is an amazing qualification. For me, it has opened many doors. Wherever I have gone, I didn't have to prove myself that my qualification was there. They accepted me. So, but still, someone very wise person once told me that your qualification should not be an obstacle to your career growth. Like, we have certain perceptions of what a chartered accountant can do. But let me tell you, our course is so rigorous, and somebody said about the syllabus also, it is so good that we cover everything and we are equipped to handle many roles. So we have to be bold and widen our vision and perceptions and be ready to accept it. And please, quantitative tool, you should not have the mental block that you don't know statistics and you don't know quantitative tools. Today you have very good software which once you understand the concept, you can use them. Okay, absolutely. Thank you.
Kindly excuse me, Dr. Pandit, we are by university professor's position, we have certain code of conduct, we have to write doctor, but if you see my mail, I never write doctor or CA, nothing, not even any qualification in my letterhead or in my signature head.
Ketan, you want to add something?
Yeah. Sir. I just want to respond to question number 4. Sir, I want to take here the name of Professor K.C. Mehta, sir, under whose legacy we are sitting here. Professor J.H. Sa, Professor Khedkar, they were all chartered accountants, but they have made us good teachers here, sir. And we, under whose leadership we have worked so hard these days, so we are sitting here. So I want to acknowledge the blazings of the stalwarts like them in Vadodara.
Very good.
And they were fundamentally very sound, sir. They were So CAs are fundamentally, conceptually very sound. I think CA are best suited for doing research.
Very good, sir. Anybody, okay, last question I have, that also we'll take, and I will conclude the session. ICAI provides scholarship for doing research, but there is age limit of 40 years. Lalit can answer about that. Why there should be an age limit? I am 62 and expert in shipping with 30 plus years of experience. I am doing research at Infianon Maritime University, Chennai. My subject is port privatization. I was told that I am not qualified to get the scholarship. Please elaborate. This is a policy decision of the ICAI.
Yes, Subhasji, actually, there are some of the decisions taken by research committee of ICAI, and there is a basic thought process before taking any such decision. So I will not be the right person to answer this question. If Vice President would have been here, he would have answered this question. What I will do is I will reply. I will try to understand this and take it forward. I understood the query, and let us address this effectively for all the youngsters in the profession.
Okay. I think the time is also ended. I will just conclude. This panel has done a wonderful job of throwing a wonderful highlight on a chartered accountant's career, whether he's in practicing or in the industry as a research career. In the every research, that is a report, has to be introduction, review of literature, data analysis, findings, conclusion, and last but not least, this is for Lalit sir, last but not least is further scope of study. I appeal to Lalit ji that if the people have the particular this one, then we can have another seminar on the research, and we can throw and highlight all the possible areas of the research, their research problem, how to construct that research problem, the variables, the test, and everything. I think I have said everything. Lalit ji, I am very thankful on behalf of all my panelist members. You are given a wonderful opportunity. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very
Subhash ji, let me just share a couple of words from my side. Because I was very much impressed from the first day itself with the panelists which we had for the session, because I understand that all of them are experts in the relevant field. And as far as research are concerned, they have contributed largely to the professional fraternity who have attended today. But let me acknowledge that Subhash ji, you have proven to be just an asset wherein you have tried to make out the best of the information from all the panelists and serve to all our participants. So really thankful to all of you, Subhash ji, and all the panelists, dignified panelists. Please be with us in any of the initiative at WIRC or ICAI as far as research is concerned. We will come back to you as and when we will need your help. With this, I have my regional council colleague Drishti Desai with me. I would request her to formally propose a hearty vote of thanks.
Thank you, man. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Lalit bhai, for this opportunity. First of all, I would like to thank the panelists, the esteemed, the learned panelists for this session. And excellent guidance that was given through this panel discussion. The moderator, C.A. Subhash Desai, could bring out the best of all the panelists. I would like to say that you really took out great amount of time for guiding us. The presentation that Professor Ketan Upadhyay also put up gave a lot of information on various sources which one can rely on. The enlightenment, I think Dr. Rajiv Parutosh Vasu could throw on what are the different areas that we as chartered accountants can look at, and why is it important really to do research from ICAI, so that even ICAI's name can be furthered. I think that's an excellent thought, and we must take it forward. See, Sanjita Pandit also excellent guidance on how research can really help one further the knowledge and the expertise in that particular field. It was amazing, I think. And see, Alok Shah, I think that was on the practical side of research that a chartered accountant can really do use of various tools. I think overall, this was an excellent seminar, and this will immensely help CAs, because CAs don't think that they are capable of doing research. But as was brought out by Sri Sangeeta Pandit, we are completely enabled by our course to do anything that we want. And research also can be undertaken very effectively by chartered accountants. Thank you so much for all of us for, you know, coming on this platform and helping the members enhance their prospects. Yes. Thank you very much. Thank
our
you,
Lalit,
for this excellent program.
It's our pleasure always, sir.
It is our pleasure to participate in the institute. Thank you very much. Thank you, Basu. Thank you, all the panelists. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Subhash ji. Thank you, Lalit ji. And thank you. Let us be in touch. Absolutely. Thank you. Certainly. Thank you.
Leave the meeting.
Leave meeting.